And away we go for today's Sunday Funday Shenanigans here on the channel with Valheim today. Looks like OBS updated their software and they moved some stuff around, so I gotta figure this out. Let me get the chat set up here. Do my normal pre-processing. Okay, so it's got a... Let me see here. Okay, my button still works. That's a good sign. And, okay, so the bottom is... Okay, so it's got like a cell phone strength bar and a kbps transmit rate, which is kind of cool. It's using a lot more CPU than it used to. Well, I guess we're gonna find out if this works or not. So today we're back here in Valheim. I haven't played this game in a long time. They've been doing other changes to it in the meantime, and I wanted to just explore how they work. Now, what they've done, one of the biggest things they've done is they've added difficulty settings. You can change the server. You can change the server criteria. Now, it only works, of course, when you first start the game. Groucho, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Happy Sunday to you, sir. Little man is currently loafed up on the floor in his most warmest position. And anyway, so they've added server settings, and there are a lot of different ways to configure the difficulty, which, as a low-skills gamer, I really appreciate, because when I played this before, I got basically to the swamp, and it just got too difficult. I could not progress that past that point. But with the new settings, I can actually play the game. I can actually see more of the game. And since I like exploration, this game features that because, you know, let's go ahead and get some stuff going here. We need to make ourselves some tools. I need to make an axe and I need to make a club. So we need to find some wood. So as most survival games are, you're the weakest when you start, but it does have some very, waiting for more snow. Yeah, you can keep that shit. It's a really well-designed game. The more I play it, the more I like it. I need to punch some trees here. Need to find some food, need to punch some trees, need to make a shelter. Because the sun, I found out the day-night cycle is, 21 minutes a day and 9 minutes a night. So it's pretty well manageable. This guy here, what I like to do first every time is, get myself some basics, right? Get a hammer, an axe, and a hammer for building, an axe for cutting trees, and a club for beating shit up. But we need wood to do that. So we're just gonna punch some bushes here until I get enough wood to do this. And then for my purposes, the thing I like to do next is find a shoreline, yeah? Because their guy starts off in what's basically the Stone Age, yeah? Come on, there it goes. Oh god, I gotta beat you with my fist. Fine. Oh, look, raspberries. So it's very well designed in that every subsystem depends on every other. Yeah. Which means you can't just focus on one thing. You gotta have everything going all the time, and that's, in my opinion, the mark of a decent survival game. Is that you're constantly making tactical and strategical decisions. You know. What up, Glandry? How you doing? Welcome to the stream. We're punching trees right now. I got to make myself some weapons, and then we got to find a shoreline. And then after that, we got to find some food, and I basically got to kill a lot of pigs and deer to get the leather scraps and other stuff that I need to make my my thing. So let's make a club real quick. Let him beat on me. I don't even care. Okay. Whipping time, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. Bam. Where this game is tricky at first is that it is really dependent on temporary buffs. It's very, very dependent on your, let's go ahead and make a hammer. And now the bird will yell at me. Look, I can't make an axe. I need more wood. Okay. So the bird's like, hey man, you gotta make yourself a thing. I know, bird, go ahead, go away. Thank you. He wants me to make a shelter. Hail warrior, you've just picked up some food, eat it. Yeah. So yeah, it all goes... I need more wood. But I have a club. Alright. Oh look, there's a shoreline right over here. Booyah! Booyah, there's a shoreline right over here. Now, there's no way I'm going to be able to chase down deer yet, so we're not going to bother with that. But you want to do is you pick up your basic stuff. Your wood, your wood, your stone. Oh, a pig. Come here, pig. I need scraps. Give me that shit. Your skills go up as you use them, and they're pretty straightforward in terms of the effects they have. You know, more damage, less stamina use, or both. But I have to find a shoreline, because down the shoreline there is a resource called flint, and flint is used to make the best weapons you can make, right? The best axe, the best spear. The various weapon types are fairly well balanced against each other as well. Clubs, the spears swing fastest. I don't need any of that right now. Clubs, spears are fastest, but they have the shortest range and the lowest target box. Yeah, you have to really hit what you're aiming at. Clubs are kind of in the middle. Axes are slow. Swords, I don't use that much, but you don't even get those at the Bronze Age, so you don't have to worry about those for a long time. So what we're doing right now is we're looking for pigs, and we're looking for wood and flint and stone, and preferably a little village that's burnt out. I like to build my first quote-unquote base. I call it a base, fortress, outpost, whatever. I like to build them on an existing area, because most of the time the game's randomly generated burnt out villages will come on a fairly flat area, which is useful. You do get a tool. You can make a tool called the hoe, which lets you level ground and raise ground. But until you get the pickaxe, you cannot dig. Yeah. So you got to be sort of judicious about where you choose to set up shop. Plus, you don't want to do a lot of running around. So what I end up doing most of the time is making small outposts like everywhere. Yeah. So I'm not too far from shelter and comfort and getting my buffs up. Two major kinds of buffs in this game, being fed and being rested. Both are very, very important. At the start, you want to be rested as much as possible because it increases your XP gain and your stamina regeneration. Later game, you want it just so you can survive, because the game depends on you being rested to do this. Marty, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Phoenix level weather, watching north. Yeah, it's chilly out here. It's 31 degrees right now. It's supposed to get down to 10. Thankfully it's just cold, but it's still pretty dry. Yeah, if it was damp, it'd be another story entirely. But okay, so let's make ourselves a stone axe. Let's get that crafted so I can cut down some freaking trees here. Okay, so I got my hammer, my club, and my axe, so I'm set. I got my combat weapon, my harvesting weapon, and I got my building thing. We're going to get a lot of flint, because we need, I don't know, probably about 30 of it. Flint's always by the shoreline. Looks like little gray bars of soap. You definitely want flint. Flint is going to be the bomb. And then one of my major things is going to be making a bow, which is going to involve some tree rolling, which would be probably not that exciting to watch, but... So now we're looking around. I generally stick to the coastline at first, just so I can get a feel for the size of the island I'm on. And... Because enemies can only come at me from one direction, right? Ooh, a pig. Come here, pig. Ooh, look at that! Pasted his ass! So anyway, about the buffs, right? Fed and rested, right? Fed gives you more strength, gives you more health and stamina. Rested gives you better regeneration and just better regeneration and an XP bonus, yeah? So at the start, you want your skills to go up so you can do more damage with your chosen weapons and whatnot. And the stamina regeneration is key, because your character can never increase your base stats, yeah? Your base health is always going to be 25. Your base health is always going to be 50. The only way to increase that is with food. Yeah. If you go to the forums on Valheim, you talk to people who play this game who are good at it, not like me, they will, when people are struggling, right, they say, oh my god, I'm having problems being this, they're all, what's your food game? Are you rested? That's the first two questions they always ask. Are you rested? What's your food game? What are you using for food buffs? Yeah. Because it makes such a huge difference. Aviator Raider, how you doing? Welcome to the streams. 55 degrees there? Nice. A little bit warmer there than here. Anybody? 32 and cloudy? Yeah, 31 and cloudy here. And I like it dry because, you know, it's good because the cold doesn't get into your skin like it does when it's wet. And but the problem is static electricity and your skin gets dry as fuck. Okay. So those are the buffs, right? Your buffs are your food and your rested. Debuffs. Yeah, debuffs. Being cold and being wet. Okay. Being cold and being wet slows your stamina regeneration. Cold is at nighttime. Wet, of course, is when you wander around the water like I'm doing. Okay. You got to keep an eye on this, man. You got to be really careful when you're cold and wet. Particularly when your rested bonus wears out, because you're just fucked. It's like you're just going to die. Like this game here, like most survival games, cardio is life, man. Stamina is life. If you got lots of stamina and a little bit of health, you'll do way better than a lot of health and no stamina. Yeah. Not the first Noel. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Happy Sunday to you. Hope you're staying warm wherever you are. So right now, the sun's going down and I'm wet. Okay. This is not optimal. This is not an ideal condition, especially since I have no food on. But since it's the beginning of the game, there's going to be very few creatures that are going to give me too much trouble. And if I die, so what? I've got it set on very easy for combat and for death penalty, which means enemies will be easier for me to kill. And if I die, I lose my stuff and a little bit of skill, but not as much as I would on a higher difficulty. And I will say this, their difficulty settings are really good. They're granular. They allow you to customize pretty much what you like and where you have difficulties yet. And at max difficulty, this game is fucking punishing, dude. It is brutal. So the people who are actually good, who want a real challenge out of this game, can get it. You know? You could turn off portals. You can turn off... You can turn off the map. Apparently, turning off the map makes this game incredibly hard. And the death penalty, you can say you lose all your items permanently and you lose all your skills. I mean, that's like holy shit, man. That's like holy shit. Okay, so it's getting dark, yeah. But we're still gathering our flint. Yeah. Now we're looking for a place to set up shop. Now, I started there. Oh, it's you. I heard the thump and I'm like, oh my god, it's not a fucking troll, is it? He's going to go, it's nighttime. Yeah? When the temperature drops or you're wet, you'll suffer from being cold. This reduces your stamina regen. Yeah? Stamina regeneration, stamina, 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 stamina. Yeah? So now it's going to get super fucking dark and then the moon's going to come up. So we're going to see how that goes. Is there a chest in there? There's no chest in here, but there may be mushrooms in here. Are there mushrooms? Mushroom. Yeah, baby. I don't generally use torches and flame because it cuts my visibility. You know, it's easier to see at night when you don't have a light in your face. As counterproductive and non-intuitive as that sounds. Okay, so we got nothing here. Let's go back up the shoreline. You'll never be cold again. Yeah, once I get it's the wolf armor, right? That protects you from the cold. I haven't gone to the mountains yet, dude. I have yet to beat bone mass on any of my characters. Okay. Because until the difficulty settings came up, there's no possible fucking way I could have done it. But on my other characters, on my original characters, I've been running around the swamp, and the swamp ain't that bad if you're prepared. You got your poison potions, and you get your food games on point. You can run around at night. It's no big deal because you're always wet, right? So you get used to that pretty quick. Yeah. Oh, also the game does have weapon and armor degradation. Not something you generally need to worry about too much, but something you want to keep an eye on. I currently do not have a workbench, so I cannot fix anything. But I'll just drop, if my club breaks, I'll just fucking drop it on the ground and make another one, because who cares? We're getting that flint, baby, we're getting that flint. But yeah, cold, wet, and no food, this is the absolute worst possible combination you can have. But it's day one or day two, and we're in the fucking meadows, man, so nothing's going to bother us. Just the cape, you'll do it. You'll die. Well, went on a rampage. Yeah, I haven't. I had the opportunity to test my combat skills on my other characters. Because what happened... Oh, a pig. Come here, pig. Yeah. No, come on, man. I found that I can take on Fuelings and Deskitos just fine with bronze weapons, with bronze gear. So I'm very happy about this. I am not someone who is very skilled, yeah? And people go, oh, you're just sitting on easy mode, blah, 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 blah. Look, I like exploring, okay? I like exploring. And I will do what's necessary to get equipped to the point where I can explore. But to me, blasting through the game, killing bosses, is not high on my list of things I like to be entertained with. This is fun. Like, I can explore an entirely new fucking map here, dude. This is awesome. But I need to at least get rid of the water debuff for now. Okay. So, food game, rested, right? Huge. These things are huge. Because your stamina... Oh, boy, pigs. Now, see, I'm probably going to die here. I only got 6 fucking health. But if I can get him... Yeah. Before he attacks me. Now, see, since I have no food buffs on, I'm not healing. Yeah? So I'm down to 6 health out of my 25. This is a problem. Yes? I could quite likely die here. But thankfully, I don't have much on me. And, we just wait for the sun to come up. Yeah? Just got to be careful that the sun comes up. All right. Let's get back to the land. All right. 300 days in Valheim World, 7 been in 400 days. Yeah, mine's at... Martin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. My current characters are at, like, at 330. Of course, part of the reason for that was I had... the original character I was playing back in the day was Scrub, right? I played Scrub, then I played Garnet, right? Scrub was my first character to learn the game. And then... okay, I'm down to 2 health. Let's eat a raspberry. Let's eat a raspberry and a mushroom. Let's get some health coming back, huh? Okay, so, now, you see I've got, 70? I've got 85 stamina now, yeah? So now I have more stamina and I got better regen. Still cold, though. Still cold. We gotta find a place to set up shop. Because I gotta make new weapons. I've got 51 flint and I've got 8. Okay, good, I can make a decent flint axe with that. Won't be able to make much armor because I have to hunt fucking deer for that. And there's no way I can hunt deer as a newbie without a ranged weapon. Some people are actually good enough with the spears to actually hunt with the spear. To throw a spear and hit something. I'm not that guy. When I throw spears, I can hit my target about 10% of the time. Yeah? So I gotta get a bow. The problem is the crude bow is a piece of shit. The fine wood bow is the business, but the crude bow... How much would I got? 13? Yeah, we're fine. Let's just cruise back up the way we came. Keep an eye out for raspberries and mushrooms. Can't really see much at night because it's fucking dark. But that's okay. That's alright. So now we're hunting for food and we're hunting for a place to make a house. Yeah? I don't know where it's going to be. But see, there's the spawn spot is that little icon. This is my spawn spot. So if I don't have a bed, if I haven't set up somewhere, that's where I'll respawn. So I don't want to stray too far from there because I got to do a corpse run. What I'm looking for is a little village or even just a single house. Because I got to make a house here. Keeping an eye out for raspberries, keeping an eye out for pigs. Yeah. But yeah, you're caveman, yeah? You just basically, and of course bees, I need bees. My health's coming back super fucking slow, but it is coming back, so that's something. Thought I saw flint over here, yeah, there we go. Gonna need lots of flint, because I need to make my axe, I need to upgrade my axe, I need to make a chopping block, and I need to make a spear. These things are kind of important for me. Nick, I will leave you alone. These things here, this little rock formation, this is a grave of some kind. If you get a pickaxe and you dig from the center down the center line, you'll find treasure. You'll find loot. I don't have a pickaxe. Slacker, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Didn't see you come in, sir. How's it going today? I hope you're staying warm, man. It's pretty fucking cold out there. Give me the stone. All right. How's my burden? 197. Also, as a survival game nod, you have very limited inventory space, both slots and weight. Yeah. You will find that when you are gathering, you will run into the weight problem more than the slot problem. That's just a way. Managing that is just a matter of knowing what to pick up and what to dump and what you can get again later and why bother. Fuck, man. Alright, well, we got enough flint, so I'm going to stay away from the shoreline. Let's go inland a little bit and see if we can't find ourselves a house like that one right there. Not great, but it's close to the spawn point. See, the problem with setting up shop here right now is I don't know how big the map is. Yeah, I don't know how big you appreciate difficulty. Well, I appreciate it because I can't do it, yeah? You're already doing very hard and restricting easy skills and weapons and starfields to make it somewhat challenging. Yeah, they didn't really balance that game to be hard. It's not difficult in almost every way. Okay, I don't like this house because I'd have to dig around these goddamn... Is there a chest in here? Oh, I don't even like this house at all. Okay. Well, shit. And look at this shit. Fucking Black Forest right here. That's kind of harsh, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, sun's coming up. Yay! True, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Oh, hey, True, now that you're here. Cheap pizza watch. Do not get Roma pizza. It sucks. I was not happy with it. It's cheap. It's less than $3, but it wasn't very good. I was talking about Jack's being bar pizza, sports bar pizza. Roma's is basically theme park, amusement park pizza. It's rough. The scenery looks different. It's pretty much the same. This is the meadows. You got your birch and your beech trees, and you got, you know, your rolling hills. But the fucking Black Forest, man, with the fir trees and pine trees is right there. That's not good. I gotta stay away from that. What do we got up here? Is that a house? Can't really tell. We're gonna stay away from the Black Forest, though. Holy shit, I'm new. No one's. How's it going? Welcome to the stream. You rocked the Kroger 3-minute pizza for a dollar. We don't have Kroger here. I got HEB, Walmart. I got HEB, Walmart, and Target pretty much. But, yeah, I'm always on the lookout for decent, cheap pizza. So far, oh my god, the fucking mountains are here? What is up with this starting spot, ladies? Holy shit, the mountains are here? You saw I got a few jacks. I hope you like them, dude. I like them a lot. Because like I said, you know, people go, oh, it's not really that great pizza. Well, dude, it's $3. I mean, really, what exactly do you expect for $3? For $3, it's a hell of a fucking pizza, yeah? Oh, is that raspberries? Raspberries! Give me that food, baby. Still haven't seen any, haven't seen any bees, and I haven't seen any, mushrooms here. But mushrooms are hard to see in the dark. Alright, the deers are all honking. I'm like, dude, I can't hunt you yet. Just relax. But we're back up to 43 health. Doing pretty good. Some more raspberries here. Oh, now it's getting fucking misty. Are you serious? I gotta be able to see a fucking house, man. We're looking for a house as we forage. Yeah, this is okay. Well, we're fucked now. Can't see more than 50 feet, dude. This is bullshit. Did I throw it in the air fryer? Did it cook good in the air fryer? Well, I don't have an air fryer, so I can't try that, but. Man, I thought I'm able to find a house. Oh, mushrooms, though. Yay, mushrooms. I was talking with, Dag in the Discord. To my mind, the mark of a good survival game, yeah, is that you're excited about finding food. When you're excited to find food, that's the mark of a good survival game. And this is, we're not going to be able to find a house. It's going to be a fucking hour to find a house, dude. I can't see anything. And happy Sunday to you as well. No one's. Happy Sunday to you. Let's get a little block action. Oh, okay. So, in terms of the combat is fairly straightforward. There are some tactical mechanics you can use. Yeah, and there's no way I'm going to get you, dude. But I slept on this as a new player for a long time, and I'm going to tell you guys, don't sleep on this. Practice parrying. Oh my god. Parrying is a game changer. Yeah? Parrying is a game changer. Once you learn how to parry, dude, the game gets 100% easier. But as a tactical thing, it takes practice. It does take a certain amount of skill, which is interesting. Yeah? Every enemy has their own telegraphed attack. They're different speeds, different angles, whatever the fuck. And once you learn their sequence, you can parry just about anything. And what parrying does, a successful parry makes a ringing noise, and it staggers the enemy. Yeah, it staggers him. And then you do multiple damage. So, yeah, you can parry with anything. But it's best to parry with a shield or a buckler, small shield or a buckler. You can parry with a weapon, but the damage will still mostly get through. I'll show you when we see if we get another. God damn, dude! What the fuck? I can't see. This is not. And you can do dev commands in this game too. You can pull up this on the Xbox. Yeah, you can pull up the dev commands and you can change any of the variables that you want, that you know how. Like right now, if I want to get rid of the mist, I could. I just put dev commands, and I put env environment clear, and then I put dev commands turn it back off, and then I will have clear weather everywhere. The problem with that is it makes the weather clear when you go into very chambers, and it's kind of weird seeing the lights on in there. So yeah, but we're just gonna roll with it for now. Yeah. Some more raspberries here because we're gonna need those. Yep. Okay, you see down the lower left how the food's blinking, how it's flashing, and it says you could eat another bite. Food does not stay at full strength for its full duration, right? When you are full, when you are fed, you will get the maximum 7 health, 20 stamina. But as the timer goes down, the buffs decrease, and that can catch you by surprise. When the numbers are flashing down there, when the icon of number is flashing like the mushroom is, you could eat something else. I could refresh the buff right now with the mushroom if I wanted to. But I'm going to let it ride because we're in the meadows. Nothing's going to bother us. I can't fucking see, dude. I hate not being able to see. Because I'm looking for something and I can't see more than about 50 feet. I'm like, well, I'm just going to wander around aimlessly through the forest here. Yeah, learn to parry. There's a two. Let's go ahead and whack. So watch. Oh, I didn't get the timing down. Come on. Nope. I don't know what they telegraph their shots as, but if we get another grayling, I'll show you. Because the graylings. Yeah, one star. Look at me go. One-star enemies have extra meat and a higher chance for trophies, as far as I've been able to determine. I hope this fucking mist clears up, man. Sure would like to be able to see. But see, we've been running around, right, for a day and a half. No problems, yeah? Let's have another mushroom. The thing about uncooked food is it doesn't last very long, like 10 minutes. Oh, mushrooms. Good. We need these, man. But you can eat a lot of stuff. You know, cooking your food is obviously very important. Boar meat and deer meat. Of course, I'm not going to be cooking much deer meat. A matter of timing, yes, a matter of timing. On some enemies, the window is very large. On some enemies, the window is very small. But it is tactically, it's very powerful. It just gets tricky when you have multiple enemies on you at one time. Because when you block one, it knocks him back and he waves his hands in the air for a second. You get an automatic critical hit or something like that. You do more damage when you hit him. And here's the fucking Black Forest again. God damn, dude. This meadows is very small. Alright, well, let's go back up here. And there's the fir trees. You gotta stay away from those. And you notice I'm not sprinting very much, right? I do have a run skill. And when I sprint, my run skill goes up. which lets me sprint farther. But sprinting makes noise, yeah? And enemies will come from a long way away when they hear you sprinting. Same thing with fighting, building, harvesting makes noise. And the enemies will come to investigate. But they go to the source of the sound. So you have a sneak. You can sneak. It takes stamina. And it's not something I'm going to worry about right now. Okay, where is he? I hear him. Here we go. He opens up. Block. See, it knocks him back a little bit. Yeah? Come on. But if you learn his attack, yeah. I can just sit here and block him all day long. It takes stamina to block, too. I need to get my blocking skill up. Because of higher blocking skill. Now, that thump means I didn't get the parry. Yeah? Which means I blocked him, but I didn't get the parry. There's the parry. Yeah? You get that ring. And sometimes what I'll do is I'll find a monster spawner and I'll just, yeah. I'll just sit there and practice my blocking for like 15 minutes. Sure do wish this mist would clear up, though. Wow. Doing good on mushrooms here. Okay. Getting frustrated. Yeah, he, they don't do very well, the Grayling Stone. Alright, here's some more strawberries, more raspberries. Get these. I see pig. A lot of the times, too, I don't know if this is a general rule or a specific one, but the boar, you will see boar around raspberry bushes a lot. Because they like root vegetables, yeah? They like eating the raspberries. Come here, big fella. Come on. Da-da-da-da. My club's wearing out. That's a problem. We need to find a place to build a fucking house, man. This mist needs to lift. Yeah, the extra damage is that little ringing noise you hear when I hit him. Ring, ring. That means you're doing extra damage. I can't see. I don't know why they think this is compelling. It's not. Oh, it's realistic. And well, yeah, I spent a lot of time in the Nord afterlife, huh? Oh, God. Oh, a pig. Stay still, piggy. Okay, you know what? Let's switch to the axe. Now, the axe hits a little bit harder, but it swings a lot slower. It's a lot slower than the club. But I should switch my weapon and work up my skill and my axe, because I'm going to need that too. As we wander aimlessly to the fog, see if we can find a goddamn house. Now see, if the fog wasn't here, I could see a couple hundred yards in every direction, so I could see a house in the distance and make my way to it. But here, I can't see a goddamn thing, so we're just going to keep harvesting our mushrooms, yeah? Well, there's another pig. Come here, piggy. Grab all that. How am I doing on weight? 245. Okay. Because I'm filling up on stones. I got too much stone on me. Need to find a goddamn house, man. Because I can't make a hoe. Can I make a hoe? No, I can't make a hoe until I have a workbench, yeah? And the workbench has got to be covered, and I don't want to sit here and dick around with that right now. That's why I like finding a house, because you can just drop the workbench right inside the house and be able to fix and make tools. Okay, this is a skeleton thing. Is there bones in here? No, no bones in here. I need the skeleton, the bone fragments to upgrade my club. The upgrading tree works pretty much like I think it would. Okay, come on. Is this mist ever going to clear up? I guess not. I guess we're going to be wandering around in the mist all day. As I try and find a fucking house. Okay. Let's keep going. Oh, god damn it. No, I'm hunting you. I'm running you down, dude. I'm gonna follow you. Yeah? If I had a spear, I could throw it at him, but I don't have a spear because I can't have a workbench, so I can't find a house. Now, the deer, when they run, they're basically NFL running backs. Yeah? They juke and weave, and they just defy every law of physics that there is. And they never get tired, ever. They will run forever. They literally can run forever. And unless he hits an obstacle, he's going to just keep running. And I just can't chase him down. I can't get him. I need to get that meat, though. Well, he's lost. One thing about the deer is if you startle them, they'll come back to where they spawned eventually. So if you're patient, you do the mighty hunter thing and you're patient, you can get them when they come back. What's that? Is that? That's just a branch. Well, at least the mist fucking cleared finally. Yeah, he's still running around loose. He's over here. You could leap him at a dagger. I'm not even ready. No, I haven't even found. I haven't even built anything yet. Yeah, but it's early time, so I can get away with this. Plus, it's on, you know, very easy, so that helps a lot. So I'm just living off of what I can forage right now while I look for a fucking house, and I can't see anything through all these trees because, of course, because I like to use established houses because I don't have a hoe. I can't make a hoe until I have a workbench, a covered workbench, and I don't just want to make a covered workbench under a tree. I mean, I can. But I want to find a house. I want to find somewhere I can start roaming from. And it's unusual for them to not have houses all over the place. Yeah. And you just can't see anything through this dense-ass forest. And there's the fucking Black Forest again, dude. Holy Jesus. I am trapped on this little... Okay, let's keep going. Seeds generate differently. Yeah, I mean, they do. It's unusual for me to see the Black Forest so close to the initial spawn point. I mean, it's not unheard of. It's just strange. And this is completely random. I didn't look it up on that website. I didn't test things out to find a good seed or whatever. 40? Yeah, we're gonna grab these. We're gonna stop grabbing raspberries when I get to 50 because that's a full stack. If I could just find a fucking house, man, it'd be great. Just one. Okay, okay, there's another pig. I see another pig over there. Piggy, come here, buddy. Oh, two of you, good. Three of you. Hope I don't fucking die here. Okay, keep an eye on that other pig. He's just walking around. Right over here. Where are you at? Okay, there we go. Get some more of that action going. That's where I was. I see more mushrooms over here, though. Now, the thing about the mushrooms is the grass will draw in... I thought I saw mushrooms over here. Didn't I see mushrooms over here? Need to get my forage. I thought I saw mushrooms, but I guess I did not. Yeah, it's fine, whatever. Okay, so where are we at? So I guess we just go north. Because this is all Black Forest here, and the mountains are right there, dude. Holy Jesus. Actually, you know what? Let's go back to our spawn spot. And hopefully we can get some vision before the sun goes down again. Oh, was that a mushroom? Yep. Okay. Oh, more mushrooms. Good. That'll tide me over until I get a goddamn fire going and get the boar going. Hey, buddy. Now the pig will run away and then he'll run back. Yeah. He doesn't really have an attack animation. So you just have to just know when he gets close to you that you can block him. How am I doing? 257? Alright, let's go ahead and eat again. Alright, off we go. Another pig, look at this shit. Doing good here. Getting some leather scraps, baby. Is there a chest up there? There is. God damn it. Can I get that fucker? God damn it. There we go. Yeah, I don't need money right now. Okay. All right. Off we go for the quest for the house. Game Town, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Is that a house there? No, that's just that's a tower. I don't really bother with those. I'm looking for this one, but that's not the right house. That's not the right house. That one's crappy. It would take me more effort to break that thing down than it would to fix it. Then it would be worth to deal with it. What I'd like to do is get a house, get a fire going, cook some meat and skeletal remains, good. I hear you, little shit. Come on. Okay, sun's going down again, so now we're gonna be fucking wandering around in the goddamn dark, so I can't. Right. Anything up here? No, nothing up here. Oh shit, where you at? The knockback in this game, however, is something you gotta keep in mind. Okay. When an enemy hits you, you weigh about 4 pounds, and it will knock you back a long way. And that is something that you need to keep in mind. When you're swimming and somebody, like a great dwarf, throws a rock at you, he will literally fling you 30 feet in the water. I'm like, okay, how's that? That doesn't even work. I just jumpy looting meat sacks. Yeah, you do it in 76 too. Super mutant meat bags. Alright, let's see if we can't find a fucking house, man. Alright, let's go this way this time. I see you, come on. And the AI is a little weird, where the enemies will run up and then just run in circles. Don't really understand the... Or they'll walk up to you and then not attack and then run away again. You're like, okay, sure. Uh-oh, little man's is playing with his fucking toy, so he's gonna be romping. Alright, I'm looking, but I'm not seeing anything here. Is that another, yeah, it looks like another stone thing to get the more skeleton bits. Because I need skeleton bits to make a club upgrade. Okay, nighttime. Nighttime's no joke because the enemies get stronger at night and they are generally more powerful. So wandering around at night is generally not advised, especially in biomes that you have not, like, mastered, that you're not, you know, if you're new to a biome, don't go out at night. And the higher level biomes, do not approach them by sea. Do not sail up to them and get out. You want to go over land. Yeah? 47? Alright, these raspberries? No. Aha! Here's a house. This is the kind I like right here. Okay, fuck it, we're setting up shop here. Okay, is there something in this house? There is no chest in this house. Okay, good. Alright, so now what we do is we take down the nearest tree. Right? You start chopping down trees. You do have a woodcutting skill, yeah? You can kill feelings, you can kill wolves. Yeah, my problem with the mountains, dude, is burning all the stamina to get up there. Yeah? That's where I run into difficulty, yeah? You have to work? Ah, well, have a good day at work, dude. Stay warm. Come on. But see, my stamina comes back at night. Look how slow it comes back. Okay, so that one's down. What we're going to do is we're going to cut every tree down that's near... There's my beech tree, my birch tree right there. Okay. So trees can and will destroy your fucking house, dude, if they fall on it. So what I want to do is clear all these things out before I start messing with this house. So if they're going to destroy it, I want them to do it now. And... Of course it gets stuck in the birch tree. Of course it gets stuck in the first tree. Fine. This is some slow going. All right, let's see if we can get some lucky. Sometimes what you want to do, if you can, is cut down trees that are close to other trees, because when they fall, they'll destroy the other trees on the way down. You got to be careful, though, because if they fall on you, they can kill you. I'm not going to say how many times that's happened to me, because I wasn't paying attention, yeah? And that one fell right into the next tree, right? See, it's doing damage, right? Not much. So now we chop down this tree and try not to get killed when that tree falls on there. And come on, you can do it. There we go. All right, we run like hell. See, look at it destroying the house, yeah? It's falling on the house. All right, then we're going to cut this tree down. Because this is right next to the house, too. Yeah. Come on. Yeah, timber indeed, man. Timber indeed. All right, which way is that going to fall? Fell over that way. All right. So we've got that going. Are there any other trees that are close to this thing? Yeah, this one here. Yeah, let's get this one. Let's get this one. Now, there's two kinds of swings, right? There's the overhand swing, and then there's the side swing. The overhand swing does more damage, takes more stamina. But since your weapon degrades with every hit you do... When I'm skilling up, right? When I'm skilling up... Okay, now we got two of them in that birch tree. That'll be fucking fun. This axe is going to break here pretty quick. I'm going to need to make a new one. Yeah, there it goes. So let's make a new one. God damn it, I didn't want to do that. Let's make another axe. Okay, switch to my next axe, yeah? Now what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and knock that birch tree down. We're going to hope that when this thing falls, it does enough damage to where it'll rattle it up a little bit. Same thing with this one, right? Now we're going to do this one. I'm going to cut this one here. Okay, good. I got a roller there. Perfect. So now we're going to cut down that birch tree. Okay. The problem is the birch tree is too hard for a stone axe. If I swing at it, it says too hard. Yeah. But other trees will damage it. So what we do, moves out of the way. And, god damn it, I don't want that. What you do is you roll the tree, yeah? You roll the tree into the other tree to knock it down. And it will fall. Yeah? So now what I can do is I can roll the birch tree into other trees, right? It will destroy them more than it can destroy itself. But what I'm waiting for, what I want to see with this birch tree is it split in half. So once it splits in half, then I can roll its pieces into each other. If I can get in here. Here we go. Get up there and jump over it. Or try and jump over it. Are you fucking kidding me? Fine. Look. Also, the physics are a little jank in that your character doesn't really have a lot of weight. Like here, I'm not sliding between the two trees because I can't push it out with my body weight. So if I can push this one, maybe? No. Can I push this one? Can we do that? There we go. So what I gotta do is roll it up. Come on. And then he'll climb over the tree, which is kind of a pain in the ass, too. All right, there we go. There we go. So I gotta get this thing out of the, I gotta get this out of the way. Yeah. Okay, maybe there? We'll try that. We'll roll it on its stump. Yeah, that'll work. Come on, Bubba. I just need you to break in half, buddy. Come on. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Because the fine wood that you get here lets you build furniture, and the furniture gives you comfort bonus, which makes your rested bonus last longer. So you want to get that as high as you can. This fucker will not break, man. Oh shit, you died. Because my jump skill sucks. Alright, so now we go back. La-di-da-di. You gotta go. Alright, Game Town, thanks for stopping by. Hope this was entertaining in some way. Yeah, I know, you feel cold, whatever. Hail Warrior, whatever, you died. Who gives a shit? I know, I don't care, dude. Yeah, I recommend building a house. I'm trying, dude. Shut the fuck up, bird. So now we're back, we're naked, right? We have no clothes, we have no weapons, we have nothing. Let's go cruise back to my death, my body. All your shit's in the, all your loot is in the little container. And the little container does not go away, ever. Okay, the game saves it to your server. I know this because on Garnet, I had died at like day 140. Yeah? To, uh-oh. I'll grab that. I had died at day 140 to, some Deskitos. And, take all, dude. Thank you. Alright. Let's try this again, shall we? Alright, Olaf. Let's get you in here, buddy. Let's do that. Do this. Let's just put the torch up here and use the fucking thing. Maybe I can see a little bit better. Okay. This fucker will not break in half, man. There it goes. That's what I wanted to see. Now what we do is we push the one hard one into the we push the one into the other. Yeah? Come on. You need to turn now. Come on, turn. 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 There we go. You are carrying too much. Okay, well, let's just drop that wood then. Alright. Now I probably won't die. Why am I still encumbered? Rocks, probably, huh? Yeah. Okay. When you're encumbered, you cannot jump, you cannot sprint, and you do not regenerate stamina. This includes when you, when you're standing still. Hey, look at that. All right. There we go. Now we're in business. Yeah? Now we start hacking and whacking. Yeah? We got a whole shitload of wood around. God, I forgot how long it takes to do it with these fucking shitty axes, man. Okay, so there's that one. I'm gonna cut you. Okay, come on. There you go. So there's that one. These two trees are probably going to give me a problem. So let's go ahead and chop this down just to get it out of the way. As we just wait for my stamina to come back because I don't have a... Come on. The problem is I got to clear these trees because I can't... If I don't, they're going to destroy my house, potentially, when I get done... getting it set up. So we gotta cut these things down first, yeah? But this is the actual worst possible axe to be doing it with. A lot of things are gonna start happening once I get a workbench. But we gotta cut these trees down first. Yeah, fell around the house. But it took a bunch of other trees with it, so more wood. Yeah. Okay. So now our house is pretty clear. What's up, bird? Yeah, carry too much luggage, I know. We gotta get rid of this one. Hope we don't die. If we do, it'll be hilarious or whatever. Okay, good. And see, the trees coming down break the other trees, which saves you axe work, yeah? Let's do it this way. Last tree. Come on, you can do it. Come on. You can do it. At the higher levels, once you get a good axe and your axe cutting skill goes up, cutting trees down, it comes very, very fast. Can you get rid of this one too? Shit. Lacking my long log. Yeah, right? Yes, because my log is 40 feet tall and covered with bark. Dude, what the fuck, Landry? Okay, good. It fell the other way. All right. So now, let's see about making this house into something I can use. I hope that grass shit goes away. If it does, it's going to make my fireplace look weird. Come on. Can we just do this? Okay. That little hit you saw is the game saving. This is normal and expected. Please log, it's a little bark on it. Just don't cut it in half and look at the rings, buddy. That's all I'm asking you. Just don't do that. I can tell you how old it is. You don't look at the rings. All right, come on. Come on, you can do it. Come on. Come on, man. Come on. There we go. All right. So now I need to figure out which way I want this house to face. It faces east. Let's get rid of that marker. Do I want this side to be the entrance? That doesn't much matter. Okay, so now what we do is build a workbench, yeah? Go hammer time, yeah? Hopefully. Yeah, let's just go ahead and build a bench right now. First thing you have to build is always a workbench. You cannot do anything until you build a workbench. Oh, shit. Here comes the bird. What's up, bird? Go away, I know. So now I've got a house that's four, and it's not... Okay, it's the low house. That's why I don't like it. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we can take this thing apart. Yeah? You cannot use a workbench. Yeah, you can't use it unless it's covered. Right? So what we're going to do is we're going to cover it. I have to build my... Let's hope we can get this thing out of the way here. Come on. Can I cut it, please, before my axe breaks? That'd be great. Every time you pick up... What you're seeing there was this new build piece, new build piece, new build piece. Whenever you get a new material, it unlocks the things you can do with it. This can come from picking it up. This can come from... What? There are a variety of ways that you can get new stuff. Some of them are a little less intuitive than others. Yeah, we gotta tear all this shit down. Also, what's cool is that the game knows structural integrity. It does calculations to see if things are adequately supported or not. And if it's not supported, it'll just destroy itself like that top thing just did. Guess we're going to do this. Right? We got that there. We got this here. And here. Right. Which way do I want to face? I want to face that way, right? So this is going to be the back. Alright, so this is going to be the back. We're going to do this and this and that. The building in this game is really, really good. It's a little bit funky. You kind of got to get used to some of its peculiarities. But it's intuitive. It's easy to modify things. Parts will snap into each other and over each other. And it has 8 different angles by default. And it's just, it's really well done. As a building type of person, I really appreciate it. Okay, so we're going to take you down. I'm going to tear you down. I'm going to rebuild you. I'm going to rebuild you right here. Yeah? Gonna build you right there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna build a cover for it. We're gonna build the rest of the house over the top of it, right? So we need to make a bed, we need to make a fire. Fire is hugely important. You cannot sleep if there's not a fire. Since I'm not building a portal in this house, we're not gonna deal with that right now. Just gonna put a roof on it. So when you put a piece up, right, you see it's angled this way, right? There's a little red arrow on the green square underneath it that tells you where the front is. If you click the left or right trigger, it rotates it by 22.5 degrees. So it's 8 8 all the way around, right? Also, what you could do now is if you click the left or right stick, it changes its snap point. It changes prioritizing snap point. This is fucking huge. I was like, oh my God, this is amazing. Because now I can build my fireplace without having to build a ladder to put the shit on the top of it, right? Things will snap pretty readily to any snappable area. Very, very handy. Jet, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. So there's my basic house, right? So now what I'm going to do is I got to cover this. Because I don't think I can use this. Let me see if I can use it. Station is too exposed. It can't stick out the back, but it has to have sufficient coverage over it. This is not covered enough. All I need to do here pretty much is just build a couple of roofs over the front of it right here, and this should do it. Right? Doesn't cost anything to fix your gear. But now what's important is I can make a hoe. But first what I'm going to do, before I even do that, is I'm building my goddamn chopping block. This takes 10 flint and 10 wood. This will allow me to upgrade my weapons to level 2, to rank 2, and it will let me build things that I can't normally build. Flint head arrows. Yeah, new arrows. So now what we're going to do is we're going to make ourselves a flint axe. Yeah. And we're going to upgrade it. Absolutely 100%. Left and right trigger to go between the tabs. Yeah. So now I've got a decent axe. These other two axes are shit. They can just go away. We're going to upgrade the hammer. Use the left and right bumpers to toggle between the active menus. And club. I can't do the club. I can't upgrade. I need stone. There it is. Let's upgrade that hammer. Yeah, upgrade the hammer. Absolutely upgrade the hammer. And then I'm going to make myself a hoe. And we're going to upgrade that if I can. Yes. So now I have new abilities, yeah? Now I can level the ground. Leveling the ground goes about, I'm going to say, leveling the ground's about, it goes up or down about a meter, meter and a half. But it's based on the level you are standing. Oh shit. There's little stubbies in the ground. Let me grab those out of here. I didn't know it had stubbies. You grab the little stubbies. Extra wood for free, baby. The stubby's right there. And there'll be a little stubby over here. These houses are where this basic form factor, I learned this from doing the house. So now what we're gonna do a little hoeing. We're gonna be a hoe. What you wanna do is stand on a level and flatten as much ground as you can from that exact spot. Because everything you flatten down will be at that level. So you can just move to the next level. Yeah. I want to do this first. Get rid of the grass in here. Okay. And then we're going to go around the house. It will raise and lower terrain. It'll raise terrain a little bit. Yeah. I'm going to use a clear little area around this house. See, but it raises the ground a little bit there. Problem is you can't lower it again without a pickaxe of some kind. But that's okay. For now, this will suffice. We're just going to get this basic thing built. Yeah. Level it out. Get it all nice. Looks like the greenery is going to stay. Which is fine, I guess. Okay. We're gonna do all that. We're gonna go back to build mode. Yeah, we're gonna build ourselves a chimney. Chimneys are tricky. Yeah. Snapping bottom. So if I snap at the bottom, I can sit on the ground and raise this thing all the way up 6 meters. Chimneys are weird because they require, it's like the smoke particles are a certain size. It's like a model that's a certain size. And if it doesn't have enough clearance, you'll suffocate, like we did with the scrub in the first stream, and I didn't really understand what was going on. Hail warrior, where the fuck are you? There you are. What do you want, bird? Landscaping, okay. Teaching me about that. I know how to use a hoe, buddy. I know all about hoes. How much stone I got? 6. Okay, I got enough. So you need to build a fire here. All right, back into build mode. Put a roof on this thing. After many, many, many tries, I came up with a... God damn it. I came up with a... 2, 3... But see, I can sit here and build the entire thing on the ground, which is such a huge, huge fucking time saver. Such a huge time saver. But the fireplace needs enough protection. It needs a roof over it so the rain doesn't put it out. Yeah, but it needs a draw. It needs enough airspace to where the smoke can get out, yeah? Because you can and will suffocate if you're not paying attention. And then, no, not there, here. The snapping can be a little wonky, but you get used to it. All right, let's build ourselves a fucking fire here, huh? All right, here we go, baby. Right there. And then we add wood to it. I'm out of wood. Well, you know what? I've got wood right outside here. Give me that. And then here... Let's go around and pick up all the loose wood that I've got running around here. Da-da-da, more seeds. Still haven't grown trees in my other games. I mean, I know you can, I just never done it. Same thing with taming boar and whatever the fuck. I'm like, I ain't got time, I'll just hunt pigs. I don't use that much meat, yeah? Alright, there's a piece of wood here. You can eat another bite, I'm fine. We're setting up our house. We're getting set up. Knows about the hose and slots. Yes, exactly. I'm going to build myself a couple of cooking stations, put them in sideways so I can put 2 of them in here. Apparently there's a way to stack like 5 of them in here. I'm like, well, that's fine. 2's enough for me. So I'm going to put one here, right? Put it over there. What is it touching? The green thing, huh? That's fine. Put 2 here. That way I can cook 4 things at once and still refill the fire easily. Yeah. Then we put this in here. Yeah. And then we put a roof over the whole thing. Now it says resting, right? You got a fire, you get covered, you got a roof over your head and a fire in your hearth. And there you go. Right? Now you got to build a bed. You don't get a better bed for a long time. You don't get a better bed till iron. You can put the bed there. Oh my god. Birds like sex me. I'm like, wait, what? Sleep the night away in your bed? Yeah. Not a fire, yeah. Just a basic fire, yeah. So we got that going, right? Claim the bed, yeah. What you want to do is put... You can mark pins with various icons. I'm just going to do this and just title it main because that's easiest for me to remember. This will come in handy later when you've got portals going. So, okay, here's my main house, right? Now we need storage. Let's put some chests up here, right? Okay, so you see up on the top where it says resting in the Z's, it says comfort 4. Okay. Comfort 4 is the level of comfort I have. The more things I put in that add comfort, the higher that number goes. Every level of comfort adds 60 seconds to your rested bonus. The base rested bonus is 8. Yeah? 8 minutes. Since it's comfort 4, I got 3 more minutes, so it's 11 minutes, right? I'm going to add some more comfort here in a minute. Yeah? It took me a long time to figure out what items gave you comfort, and I didn't really understand it for the longest. Okay, so there we go. We got 2 of those. Let's just get rid of all this other shit. I'm just gonna drop it on the fucking ground. Get rid of the stone axes. Don't need those. Don't need that. Okay. Keep those. Keep the club here. Right. Do that. Yeah, that's what I want right there. Okay. That's what we got. All right. So here's our little house. It's coming along. It's coming along. It's looking livable. So now I need to chop some trees. But this flint axe is going to be a lot better for this. Yeah. Yeah, 5 swings. Okay, let's go ahead and eat that really quick. So I can do my job here. Caveman style. Nice tent. This is these houses I build, Aviator, I basically modeled it off the houses I was seeing in the game. Yeah? So I basically repurposed what they were doing with their prefab houses and then modified it to the way I wanted it. Yeah? Okay, the reason I'm pushing this thing is I don't want it rolling down the hill when I cut it in half. See, now it's really going to roll the correct way. Always keep an eye on which way it's going to roll when it splits, man. Because you don't want to get killed by it like we did earlier. And you don't want it rolling away from you. Like, this thing would have rolled all the way down that hill. I'm like, no, we're not doing that. But yeah, my houses, my little outpost, it's a proc gen house with some flair, yeah. Most of my outposts in the game look exactly like this, with one exception. There's a sidecar for the teleporter. I always put the portal in the house. I used to put the portal outside the house, but I found it to be much more convenient to the portal in the house when I've got a stake wall up, because that way when I come into my new area, I don't have to worry about getting jumped or, you know, getting caught out in the rain or whatever the fuck, yeah? Didn't want to deal with that. But see how fast I'm up now. Watch. Look how fast my stamina comes back right now. Yeah? That's the rested. That's what being rested does for you. Now when it gets cold, it will come back slower. And if I'm cold and wet, it will come back even slower. So the worst case scenario, of course, is if you're cold and wet and not rested and broken weapons in an area that you're not supposed to be in. Yeah, that you're not familiar with. But you see, we're skilling up a lot faster too, yeah? Because if you look at the, not skills, is it trope? Where is my active effects? Rested. You feel rested. Health regen plus 50%, stamina plus 100%, Eiter, which is your mana, 100%. And you also get, of course, experience. So let's finish this thing up here. Let's get our chests in here. Put our other chests in here. 1, 2, 3. Since this is main, we're going to need 5. But see, look how the chest goes into the other chest. So nice, man. And we're going to do 5, right? 5 chests there. Come on, go there. And now I have a choice to make. How much fine wood do I have? Did I get it all? I got it all. I have 14 fine wood. That's exactly as much as I need. So to add comfort, what you do is you can put a deerskin rug down, which I don't have yet. But you can also build furniture out of fine wood. Right? We're going to slide this table into the wall as far as I can. Get it out of the way. Yeah. And right, come on. God damn it, right there. Now watch my comfort. It goes from 4 to 5. Yeah. Putting this chair in will bring it to 7. Comfort 7. Then what I'm going to do is put this up here, this little banner. I didn't even know the banners added comfort, but I'm like, oh yeah, the banner adds comfort. So now you take the banner and you put it up here. The trick to the comfort is the items that add comfort have to be within 10 meters of you. So shit like maypoles, Christmas trees, and crap like that. But now it's just comfort 8, right? So my rested bonus, I'll stay here for a second. Actually, let's cook some meat. Let's do that. Let's get that going. Meat takes 25 seconds to cook. So we're going to sit here and watch that comfort bonus. It's going to go up to like, what, 16 minutes? 15 minutes, I think. It takes it a minute. Yeah, now I have 15 minutes of buffs, yeah, instead of 8, which is the basic one. But, you know, if you got a bed, a fire, and a roof over your head, that's comfort 3, so you're good there. Or comfort 4. The highest it can get is, like, I don't know, 16 or 17 or 20 or something crazy. With a maypole and an armor stand and a dragon throne and or a raven throne and a dragon bed and a tree... There's all kinds of shit you can do to add comfort. Generally, if I get to 11, I'm doing pretty good. Most times, 8 or 9. Once I get a deer, once I kill some deer and get a deerskin rug down here, that'd be comfort 9. I'm going to put my food up on the bar here. Put you there. Put you here. And the next task, of course, is just find some bees. Yeah? Find some bees. Da, 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 da. But now my food buffs are a little bit better, right? Now I've got a meat buff and 2 vegetable buffs, which means I'm going to have better health and slightly more stamina. Alright, you go in there. We're going to put the food in here. I'm going to put you in there. No, can't put you in there yet. Secondary crafting shit goes in there. Seeds and shit go in here. Seeds go in there. Secondary crafting goes there. Okay. We're getting there. That'll be 20. Right, okay. Put the food in here. Extra food goes in there. Secondary crafting goes here. Right? And then primary goes in here. One thing they did add too is if you put an item in a box and you click the right stick, it puts everything in that box. It auto stacks the stuff that's in your box. Very handy. That is a UI change that I like a lot. Okay, so we're gonna put all that crap in here for now. And then we're gonna put this in the food bin. Yeah. So now we're a lot lighter, we're only at 41. Yeah? Oh no, don't take that off. What does it take to make leather armor? Take deer hide, right? Oh, I can't make leather. It takes deer hide. I can't make leather armor. I haven't picked up any deer hide yet. Okay. Good. So there's my loadout, yeah? There's our loadout. We got food. We got weapons. We are set to fucking go. What I'm going to do is drop this hammer in the box here. So I'm not going to need that in my travels. We're going to need the club and the axe and the hoe can stay in there. So there he is, right? We got our house. Actually, I need to put a door on this fucking thing. Let's get that done. Okay. Let's get our trim on here. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go there. And then we put this over here. Come on, go there. And then we'll put a door in it. When I put the door in, just so you know, the door opens from the handle back. The hinges are on the right, doors on the left, right? I always put the door to where it'll open on the workbench because I very rarely need to get to the workbench, right? So when I open the door, it opens on the workbench side. I can still get to the workbench, but it doesn't block up any of my chests. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to go fix the hammer. I'm going to put it away. Along with the wood. And we're going to sleep. Ta-da-da-da. But that's it. Now I have my first base. Now we can wander, right? Now we go forage. We're going to try and make weapons. Try and upgrade our armor. Trying to get some armor done. Stock up some food. Right? Trying to get killed. That's kind of a big one. So now I eat. Yeah? What I need to make is a fucking shield. So we're going to do this. I think I need wood and leather. Let's see. Wood shield. I need resin. Okay, the resin's in here. Okay, I need wood, leather, and resin to make a wood shield. Now this one here, right? If you look on the stats, weight, durability, block armor, block force, parry bonus. Parry bonus lets you know that this is a parrying weapon. The tower shield has a lot more block force, right? And a higher block armor, but you cannot parry with it. Always have a shield you can parry with. Nope, don't do that. I want to change the style. I want a cool looking shield. If you press A, you can change the style. We're going to go for this one, I think. Yeah, craft a shield. Can I upgrade it? Sure can. So we're going to upgrade it. Upgrade everything. Club, I need 5 bone fragments. How many do I have? 4. Of course, I've got 4. What? Pfft. Shit. So now I need to find another bone fragment. Upgrade my whipping stick. But, yeah, now I got a shield, baby. Now we got a shield. We're going to move this over here. Yeah. All right, now we're rolling. Maybe I should put his clothes on, though. I mean, it's only one armor, but it's better than nothing. One of the best building mechanics. Martin, I agree. It's really... It's fluid. It's intuitive. Yeah. It's extremely user-friendly. And it's forgiving. It lets you clip pieces into pieces like no problem. And that's, for me, that's just gigantic. Yeah. Actually, you know what? We're going to stock up on wood first. Yeah. I can't get rid of that rock yet because I don't have a pickaxe. Let's get some wood going here. See, normally at this point I would build a stake wall around the house, but I've turned off raids. I don't have raids in my... I enable portals, right? Portals can take metal, and there are no raids. I don't find them entertaining. I don't find them fun. But yeah, I like it. It took a little bit to get used to, yeah. But once you learn it, it's very, very quick to put, like that basic building, right? We put it up like 15 minutes, like done. No problem. Okay. Chop this wood here. Just do some maintenance. But the rest of bonus, right? My stamina comes back fast, and my skills go up fast. So I'm like, this is good. All right, we got that, and we got these two. Now, the axe has an arc, and it will do damage to everything in its path. However, it can only do so much damage per swing. So that you can see the numbers are lower as it divides the damage up between the two targets. This is something that is a problem when you're fighting enemies in trees and rocks and shit, because the trees will take some of the damage that you're doing, and the enemies won't get damaged. All right, there's that. Wasn't there one down here? Yeah, there's one down here. Now here's the tricky part, right? This fucker's on some raspberry bushes. God damn it, get up there. I do wish that my little Viking could climb better than he does. That'd be nice. So now I have to look at this log and go, okay, if I split this thing in half, which part's going to roll down the hill? I'm going to guess it's that one, so what I'm going to do is go over here, if I can not slide down the fucking hill. Can I get it from here? Okay, so now we're going to gamble. Or we can just destroy a bunch of raspberry bushes. Yeah, we can do that too. I mean, don't get me wrong, Martin. Raids would be really fun when you have multiple people on a server. Like, you got like 5 or 6 people playing. Raids are a hell of a blast, man. Because, you know, you can defend your home and shit. But as a lone player, they suck because I have to do everything. And it's just like, it just sucks. Okay. I'm gambling that this half is going to roll and the other half won't. We'll see how it goes. Perfect. So now I cut this one. Using my body to keep from rolling down the goddamn hill. And the other piece got stuck over here. So I'm going to chop down instead of over because I don't want to push it anymore than I have to. Okay. Perfect. Gonna jump around and get these stones. Of course, get my jump skill up too, right? Because I'm rested. Okay, so homeboy here is now moderately equipped. He's got the basic kit, right? A tree chopper, a hammer, a club for doing, you know, whatever. So his next goal here is going to be getting equipment. He needs to get a better workbench. To upgrade this, I need to make to upgrade the workbench now. I need to make. We're going to do this. I'm going to do a little more building here. To upgrade the workbench, I need to build this thing. No, I need to build. I haven't killed a deer yet. I can't even do that. Never mind. It's a tanning rack is the next thing you need. And wooden leather scraps. I need to make a bow, too. So we're going to do that. We're going to make a bow. I need a ranged weapon. Leather scraps are in here. God, I don't even have enough leather scraps, do I? No. I need 8. I've only got 7. Fuck. Gotta go kill some more pigs. Okay, so we're not doing that today. But I gotta kill deer, right? Deer give me better meat. They give the deer meat is better than boar for buffs. The deer have hides, which let me make all kinds of shit. But I don't have a, I can't make a bow until I kill more pigs. So we're gonna flatten this out instead and build ourselves a stake wall here. We're gonna finish this thing up a little bit if I can. We're gonna see how much it lets me get away with here. Here, there, yeah, okay. Let's go back to this. Keep making our thing here. We're gonna finish this thing up a little bit, yeah? I didn't want that, I want this. But you can see, right, that when I do this, it pushes it out a little bit. If the ground next to it is low enough, it'll actually raise the terrain enough to give you purchase. Now, it won't do it there. What you can do on those, right, get yourself some stone. You're gonna need lots of rock for this. Is you can raise the terrain. Chop this bush down, so it's going to be in my way anyways. And you're going to be in the way, so get rid of you. And then you. But you can see already that I've raised this section up a pretty good amount, right? So what you do is you go here, your level ground, right? And if you look real close, you can see a thin line going from the center of the radar pulse to the ground. This tells me that the ground underneath the cursor is that much lower than the ground I'm standing on. Yeah. What you do is you go over here to say raise ground. It costs you 2 stone, gotta be near a workbench. Pop. Do that, and then you lower it again. This only works from going up. You can't go down. Yeah. You can't go down. But a lot of times when you raise the ground, it'll finesse the terrain next to it to where I can raise stuff next to it, right? Like there, that one's not done, right? So we move this out, move the cursor over a little bit over there, and then lower it again. Chunk it, lower it, raise it, lower it, raise it, lower it. But that lets me sculpt the terrain a little bit, yeah? Which is really useful. Like I said, you just can't dig. You can only raise, you can't lower. And there's another one there. I don't have any stone. But that's okay. We're just going to see what we can get away with over here. Yeah, that's about as high as it can go. Because you see how high it is here? It won't drag it from this depth. It won't drag it from this lowness. But over here, this corner, it probably will. Yeah, see? Totally did it. Rocks and trees won't be destroyed. If you take the ground out from underneath something you built, it can break it. Starkiller, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. We're gonna make a little. I'll make a little stake wall here if I can. Now, see here, I'm stuck. Right, this is too much dirt for it to lower. I mean, it's mutating it on the top a little bit, but I'm not getting a lot of play here, so I can't do much with that section right there until I get a pickaxe. I need to be able to chop at the ground, but the pickaxes come from Ike there. Yeah, so we don't really do nothing with that yet. We can give her some shrubs here. So there's my little house, right? Yeah, we can totally do this. So now what I do, now my next step is to build a stake wall around the house. Since I'm not getting raided, I technically don't have to. But the thing is, enemies will not attack something they can't see. So if I put a wall up around this, yeah, if I put a wall up around this, the enemies won't be able to see the stuff inside it. Yeah, this ain't gonna work. It's gonna float. I don't care. What I do is I make a little round corner, yeah. I use this as a spacer to tell me how far I am from the house. And these things take a shitload of wood. 4 wood apiece, yeah. What I do is I go to the edge of the house, right? The width of the house, and then I just click once to angle it. 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 This is a little bit snug, but that's okay. And then we angle it again. No, not like that. When you destroy something you built, you get all the materials back. Because you can't pick things up and move them. You have to destroy them and rebuild them. That rock is going to be a problem. The question is, will it let me snap to the rock? Yes. 76 wouldn't, but this game sure will. Oh, I love it. Once you get the hang of it though, it's very easy. Also, the stake walls snap to each other if you put the cursor at the top junction. So you can make your wall too high all the way around with any support. You can do it three high too, but they start to turn yellow when they're up that high. Okay. So here we go, right? And then I'm gonna take that out, and we're gonna take the door out. Because once I get my thing in here, actually let's build my gate right now. Let's do that. 10, I'm gonna need some more wood. All right, so here we go, right? Here's our little camp. Yeah, it's getting there. Yeah, that tree looks pretty close. Let's get rid of that tree right there. Let's get rid of you, homie. Can lure a train with a pickaxe only after you kill Ike there. And what I do is, when I go building, yeah, I will generally use the antler pickaxe rather than a bronze pickaxe. I actually prefer using it because the bronze pickaxe requires a forge to repair. The antler pickaxe just requires a workbench anywhere. So I can do, did I start a new world? Yes, I started a new seed. Just to go over the differences, the stuff that I learned, Starkiller, basically, the stuff that I've learned, right? And how it's useful to get set up, yeah? Because once you get set up, you're done. You don't have to really, like, do this over and over and over. I mean, you kind of do when you're wandering around. You need, you know, a place to sleep and eat or cook food really fast when you're out way away from your house. But once you get portals, whatever, you know, you just come right back to your house and it's okay. Okay, let's go ahead and build the gateway here. We need to get this one here. Now, see on the bottom there, you can see there's a little, I don't know if you can see it or not. There's like a little red triangle that's pulsing out from the thing. That's the front of the object. So if you want to line things up all the same, you have a visual guide. Yeah. You can do that. You can do this. And then we're going to do... let's see if I can even jump up on here. Okay, good. I did. You can't breathe. That's okay. I'm getting out of the way. All right, here we go. I have resin on me. Good. Okay. Now what I do is I put my markers up here. I put my torches up here, which I rarely get centered because I can't really tell from this angle where they're at. Put those up there, yeah? Got corrupted. Ah, man. Yeah, that's the thing, man. When they add things with the seeds, it's just like... I start over all the time, though. I mean, I start over all the time. Because it's just, it's more fun to have the... which way I want this open? I want to open this way. Okay. So there's that. Only got 10 wood left, so let's go ahead and put this shit away here. Put that in there. Actually, let's top off the resin. I like to put the torches over the gate so I can see where the entrance is. When I'm coming in, you know, and it's raining or dark or whatever, I can see where the entrance is. Yeah. Okay, now I gotta go chop some more fucking trees. Did I leave some stumps over here or anything over here? No, you're too close. I gotta cut you down too. Come on, big fella. Well, that hurt. Almost killed me again. Cause of death, log. Okay, so this thing is stuck on something, but I don't know what it's stuck on. It's stuck on the rock over there. So I cut this side, because I know that when it splits in half, it's not going to roll. Or it did. Whatever, it's fine. All right. Gonna finish this steak wall, sleep again, and then go get something. They got plenty of food though, man. I got 19 boar meat. I got 26. I got plenty of food. I got plenty of food. Gotta manage my logs, dude. I guess I'm getting killed by them, dude. That's what it is. Oh, this one in here. See, this is a tricky one, right? Because I know it's stuck in the tree, but I couldn't tell you which way it's gonna fall. So we're gonna find out. Getting ready to run every time I swing. I'm like, yeah. Okay, run away. Hide behind this tree. I'll be safe back here. Gotta hide behind the other tree. Because these things do a lot of damage, man. Story of man. Yeah, right? Alright, here we go. But see, once I get all this shit squared away, right? Once I get a place to sleep and eat and refresh my bonuses and shit, now it's time to run around and look at stuff, man. See what I can find out there. Now that I got a shield to parry with, I could probably inch into the Black Forest. That's what I gotta make, too. I gotta make a spear. Carry lots of weapons, man. Always carry lots of weapons, yeah? Because they do different types of damage, right? Axe does slash. Axe does slash. Clubs do blunt. And bows and spears do pierce. Because what we need to do is go into Black Forest and find ourselves some pine. We need to find some pine trees. Because we need to get ourselves some core wood. And then we need to do some log rolling to get these beech trees up. Start you right next to the Black Forest? Yikes. Yeah, this one here is pretty close to the start spot. Closer than I like, certainly. But it'll be handy to go in there because I need bones for my fucking club. I need to get skeleton parts of the club, and there's lots of skeletons in the Black Forest. Hey, look at that. We got the beech tree. We got the birch tree. Yow. Okay, now slow down. There you go. This thing is the money. I need this thing. Oh, no. Well, I guess as long as it splits in half, that'll be okay. Okay, you know, I'm going to eat. No, not yet. Let's get out of the way. Okay, let's make sure I got some health, yeah? Another thing about having high health, right? Your ability to resist getting staggered depends on your health, okay? Fuck's sake, will you break? One more, Amy. Don't get run over. I already did, dude. I already got killed by a tree. My first death. Killed by a fucking tree, man. It's a hell of a way to go. Death by log. Come on, man. Just split in half, for fuck's sake, dude. 6.9, 7. Okay, good. Big log. Come on, buddy. I guess I can roll it at the stump. Okay, good. It's stuck underneath that tree, which means it'll probably... Come on, man. You can do this. I won't this fucking birch tree break, dude. There we go. Usually didn't take that long, man. Push you out of the way here. So now what I do, yeah, is I roll the birch into each other. Yeah? If I can get it set up there. Come on. There we go. Maybe you? Can I get you to rotate? Can I get you to rotate? Come on, man. There you go. There we go. Oh, yeah. Log rolling for fun and profit, baby. But this is the only way to get birch before you kill Ike there. And that bow that you can make with the... that fine wood bow, dude, is just... It's all kinds of love. I hate the crude bow so much, man. But the problem is I think you need leather to make the fine wood bow. Which means I'm going to need to kill deer anyways. You can do it. Here we go. There we go. There's some. And now this one. Where's a good spot to roll it into? That other tree right there? Yeah, that'd be pretty good. You just rotate it, right? When it starts to roll, push one of the ends and it'll spin. The physics are pretty consistent. Crude bow doesn't... The crude bow is workable, but you gotta realize it's got a really It's got a really weak pull. So it's you have to arc it way higher than you do. And the arrows travel slower so the wind can grab them more. But the crude bow is perfectly usable. It's just it takes a lot of practice because of its jank. The fine wood bow shoots flat and straight and is very, very rarely affected by wind. So it has that going for it, right? Look at this shit. That birch tree actually knocked down another tree before it broke. Come on, man. Get in there. Will you fucking... If this thing breaks the stump, dude, I'm gonna be all, are you serious with this shit? Come on. This birch is crazy hard, man. It's never taken me this long to break one of these fuckers before. This never happened to me before, I swear. Look at that. It broke the tree and the fucking stump, dude, and it's still intact. You shit. Come on. No, it didn't even hit the tree. Are you fucking kidding me, dude? All right, come on. Up you go. Up you go. A little bit more. Come on. Come on. No, not that way. And it rolled under. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Get up there, you piece of shit. Get up there. 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 Oh, no. No, 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 no. I can't get a break here, dude. I cannot get a break here. Literally, I can't get a break. It won't break. There we go. Okay, we gotta move you up a little bit this way. Come on. Come on, go up this way. Let me zoom in a little bit more here. There we go. God damn. Get a little more speed there. See if you can't get it to hit it. This fucking thing won't break, dude. Why won't this break? Will you just fucking break, dude? This is nuts, friends. This is nuts. This fucking beach thing is first is taking out two trees already and a stump. And I'm like, it won't break. Will you fucking break, dude? If this knocks down that tree, I swear to God, dude. That's why it's called hardwood. This, no, dude, this is beyond hardwood. Ancient trees are softer than this, dude. Look at this shit. I mean, are you seriously fucking kidding me with this? Why will this thing not break? I've never seen a birch this hard to fucking break, dude. Come on. It just won't break. If it breaks that stump, I'm done. I'm gonna go do something else. This is fucking stupid. I'm starting to think it might be bugged. There. Jesus fucking Christ. Are you kidding me? Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. This fucking birch. All right. Grab some resin here. All right. We need to hunt pigs. First, what we need to do is finish our wall. Yeah? It's magical birchwood. It's bullshit's what it is, man. How much wood do I have? Well, I got plenty. I got enough to finish it. All right. Let's finish this thing. You feel cold. That's fine. I need to finish my wall, man. Miscellaneous. All right. Let's get this rolling, yeah? Let's get this rolling. Here. And here. And in the later game, you can grow plants, you can tame boar. Plant growing needs some work. It would be nice if it were a little more... I guess what I don't like is I don't like having to guess if a plant is too close. And I don't like the fact that I can't pull a plant up if it is too close. Yeah? Because if you plant carrots or turnips too close together, they won't grow. They just it just basically eats the seed. It doesn't work. But I think it would be nice if the plant would only be plantable if it were the correct distance. Yeah. If it were too close, it just wouldn't plant. That would be a nice feature. Or, you know, some kind of mesh you could lay over with snappable plots. Because sitting there fiddling with the fucking plants is just, I mean, yeah, it's realistic, I guess, but it's not very much fun. And it'd still take the same amount of time. You still have to plant them by hand, you know? All right, and then, how much wood I got? 16, 17? Yeah, we could put this one up here. I'm going to put the trim pieces on my house here real quick. Top. Shape a top here. Put you there. Put you there. And then we'll put the roof, put the things here. Snap top one. Thank you. Put that here and here. Come on. And there and here. Okay. Pretty good. Still got 21 wood left. We could do it on the other side then. Sure. Let's do it again. Get this piece here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Snapping top. Yeah, snap you there. And we're going to snap you here. And then go back to the other one here and do that. Yeah. Top one. Put you there, and here, and there, and here. Okay, so there we go. Finished house, right? Make a grid with the small wood frames. I use the small wood frames as a guide. Yeah, I put like 20 of them, 20 of the little wood stubs on the sidewall, and use that to line them up. But it's still a pain in the ass, you know? It would just be nice if it just would work. Put that in there, put that in there, put the wood in here. And we're going to put you there. Now what we're looking for is we're looking for these motherfuckers. We're looking for boar. We need piggies. But first, we need a spear. Hopefully I can make it with 9 of these. Flint spear? Can I make a flint spear? I need fucking leather scraps. Are you shitting me, dude? Fine. We need to make a spear. Here we go. Flint spear upgrade. Needs more scraps, but I need to fly flint. We're gonna do that. We're gonna take a chance, yeah? We gotta kill a shitload of pigs, though, man. I mean, a shitload of pigs. And, flint spear upgrade. So now every one of my weapons is ranked 2, except for my club, because I need bone shards for that. Because we're gonna put this away and that away. Put the spear up over here. So yeah, now it's time for... You can't sleep at this time. Man, sun came up. Okay, well, I was going to sleep, but I guess I'm not now. Okay, so now we're going to do... is going to explore. We're going to look for pigs, and we're going to look for deer. Look for pigs. We just need pigs. We need lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of pigs. Because we need leather scraps for fucking everything. Yeah. How much do I have for 12, huh? Okay. Let's get it on. Let's get rolling. But there we go. After what? A half an hour? 40 minutes? We got ourselves a nice fortified little comfortable place that we could sleep and cook and do all the shit that we need to do. Now we're going to go south looking for fucking pigs. Leave all this wood here for later. It's not going anywhere. Kind of a steep little hill with a river there. Not really feeling that. Dun, 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 dun. But yeah, we're basically looking for pigs because we cannot kill deer. Oh, there's some. No, this deer. God damn it! Wait a minute. We got any bones in here? No, no bones. But we got some raspberries. I hear you hooting and honking, you little piece of shit. You just wait till I get a bow. If we get a bow, it's going to be a game changer, homie.
Look for pigs. How you doing, Dalton? Welcome to the stream. How's it going, sir?
Staying warm down there, man? Hope you're staying warm, buddy. It's fucking cold, man. It is too fucking cold. People say hell is fire. I say hell is ice. I'm just going to say it. Being frozen is just the worst, man. Yeah, you keep barking, motherfucker. Let me get a bow. Just let me get a bow, dude. I will put paid to your honking ass. What are we doing here? Okay. So here's the water. Looks like we can go over this way. So let's try over this way. Not seeing any pigs, though. We need the piggies. Where's the piggies? God damn it. Get out of the fucking water. Boy, you know what? The jumping physics could use some work, okay? The jumping and climbing physics could use some work. I literally can't get out of this water, dude. Okay? And I should be able to just climb out of this water. Look at this. I cannot get out of this water. Jesus fucking Christ, dude. Okay. Now, I can't swim very well, because swimming takes a shitload of stamina, and I ain't got a lot. But now we're wet, so our stamina comes back slower. And, but yeah, the climbing physics and the grade physics, the fact that he can't climb very far, very steep hills, that always just bothers me with every game. And this game is no exception. Come on, big fella. Yeah, he's just running in circles. I mean, you know, what the hell? Boom, bitch. Run around in circles again. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Kind of realistic to climb muddy banks. Yeah, I mean, in a way, I kind of agree, but, you know. He's not wearing a back brace. I could just kneel, you know, crawl. You could totally do that. I mean, if it was vertical, sure, I could totally see that, but this kind of grade? This is where you dig in your hands and you just fucking pull yourself out, dude. But he's got a back brace on. He can't bend at all. Which is why the spear doesn't go down to the ground. If it's at his ankles, he won't hit it. Okay, let's see if we can swim across here. Get to watch for a couple weeks. Going to Canary Islands. Nice! Going to Canary Islands. Look at you! Sod that drop to warmer climates. Yeah, I wish I could be, dude. Hey, look, pigs! Piggies. Now, hopefully they don't run away. Yeah. Hope they stay put. There's one right there. If I had a bow, I could just shoot his ass, but... See, the problem is sprinting up to him. Right? Well, there's lots of them here. Good. Come here. Yeah, the boar don't have a problem getting out of the water. He's like, whatever. Dude, come on, piggies. Don't wander off, buddy. Don't wander off. Two of them. Look at this shit. All right. Pigs always run at me. If you aggravate them, they'll attack. Yeah? But if you don't get near them and you don't sprint around them, they just kind of wander around. And I saw one on the other bank, but he's just fucking gone, dude. Where the hell did he even go? I mean, seriously, where did he go? Did he teleport? Oh, he's over there. Is it you up here? There you are. Piggy. A note on combat. Don't do what I'm doing right now, which is sprint into combat and then attack. Because sprinting uses a shitload of fucking stamina. And by the time you get there, you will be too tired to swing. So, managing stamina is this game's real... Is this game's real difficulty setting. Yeah? I could wait for those two pigs. Swined up. Yeah, something like that, Grodger. You could breed the pigs, Grodger. Dalton, if you aggro them, right, and lead them, because they'll chase you forever, right? Once you piss them off, they will chase you forever. What you can do is you can lead them back into your camp, into your base, right? Where you've got a pen set up, right? So you get them in there, and then you build a wall, and you wall them in, right? Once they're in there and they're calmed down, you throw in, you know, you can throw in mushrooms or raspberries to feed them. But if you leave them alone long enough, they'll make little piggies. And then you can, there's a special knife you use to slaughter them. You get more meat. No, they won't do that in the wild. You can't lure them, you can't tame them with that way. I thought you could. I'm like, how do I feed this thing? But you can't. What you do is you piss them off, get them in a pen, and then throw a bunch of food in. that's how it works. But once you do, you can breed them. They'll breed. Once they calm down and accept their new situation, yeah. And this is a thing, yeah. I tried it like 3 times and I got bored of it. I'm like, I don't really need boar meat that bad. And once you get to the swamp, you're drowning in leather scraps because the muddy scrap piles have lots of leather scraps in them. What I'd like to know, what I was thinking about yesterday, because I think about weird shit like this. For the Valheim players, when you go in the swamp, you can kill leeches, right? Leeches are in the water. They do poison damage, whatever the fuck. When you kill them, you get something called a blood bag. Okay. Seems reasonable. It's a leech, right? My question to you, Valheim players, is what the fuck are these leeches getting blood from? There's blobs and oozes. They've got gunk and shit. There ain't blood. You've got gray dwarfs with straggling from the Black Forest, and they're made of resin. You got the Draugr, who are fucking zombies. Dude, they're undead. They literally don't bleed at all. And then you got the Abomination, which is a tree. I mean, where the fuck are these leeches getting the blood from, dude? Nothing out there bleeds except you. Are they killing that many dead Vikings? But we don't have blood. We're spirits, dude. Ah, there's another house. Look at this. We got beehive in here? No beehive. I need bees too. We need bees. I need to make honey. Yeah. Because honey is awesome stamina food, man. Only the one mushroom? Oh, did I just hear a skeleton? Yes, I heard a skeleton. Come on, man. Where are you at? I probably should have no. Oh, what we got? Oh, it's a tower. Because there's going to be a lot of them. Hopefully, there's anyone with a bow. If there's one with a bow, I'm pretty fucked. Skeletons, man, will fuck shit up. Well met. Yeah, I'm kind of busy at the moment, homie. Come on. Back up. Let your stamina come back. Yeah, you want it? Bitch. Come. Uh-oh. There's a one star. Come on, big fella. See, now we're gonna get in trouble, yeah? Come on, three at once? And I got rags on? Come on. What the fuck, dude? Okay, fine. Now I gotta get clear, I can't see behind me, yeah? Come on. Yeah, fuck you. Okay. Tactical situation, right? Isolate them. Get out of the fucking way, dude. Come on. There you go. The problem is, right? Fighting makes noise and it brings more of them. Come on. Let's go, bitch. Yeah, don't attack me. Just push me and then run around. Yeah, sure. Yeah, fuck you. Okay, that should not have ended like it did, but Jesus fucking Christ, dude. Yeah, Hugo, I'm busy, dude. Yeah, I know, Black Forest. Shut up. Let's get back and get these skeletons, which is the whole reason I came over here in the fucking first place. But that got a little out of hand. Da, 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 da. But you, so in terms of the, you don't have a bow, good. In terms of tactically fighting, yeah, whatever, traitors, yeah, I don't give a shit. That's how you manage multiple combat. You back up a lot, right? You pick your shots, you block, you try to keep your stamina up. But there's a lot that goes into that shit. And when you get adds, man, it goes sideways pretty fast. And that's not good. There's only you up there, which means there's got to be another bone around here. How many bones did I get? Two? Let's go up and get this dumbass. See if there's a chest up here. Probably not, but... at the very least, we got to get... yeah, just you, huh? Come on. Yeah. Fuck you, dude. Now, you see how the numbers are yellow on him? Yellow indicates they're weak to that element. Skeletons, obviously, are weak to blunt because they're fucking bones. Trolls are weak to pierce. Blobs in the swamp are weak to blunt. So try different weapons. If you're getting gray numbers, you're using the wrong weapon. White, you want... gray is the worst. White is next. White is average. And then yellow is superior. You see yellow numbers, you know you're in business. That's the weapon you want to use all the time. I don't think gray doors are weak to anything except fire, but I don't really make fire arrows or anything. I use them because they take too long to work. Okay, so this... so here's a house that I will probably want to use at some point. Yeah. So I'm going to mark this with the little fire. Just with a little fire. So, okay, that's a potential house that I can develop, I can move into later, maybe, if I need to. Because it's right on the edge of the Black Forest, too. And that will help a lot in terms of harvesting materials and shit. Come here, you. There's some fucking deer over there. Okay, let's see if I can do this. Let me just kill your dumbass. Okay, so what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and spear this fucking deer. I'm going to sneak up on him, yeah, while using a lot of stamina, right, and then we wait. I'm not good with the spear. There? I got one! Nice, I actually fucking got one. All right, so that's how you hunt without, that's how you hunt range without a bow. But I actually fucking got one. How about those apples? We got one. All right. So that's spears. Yeah. Spears. I haven't used them enough to get the arc right. Yeah. Well, clearly I did there. But he's a boar. He wasn't really moving around very much. I could just run up to him. Spears are great, except when you stab. Right. It's really fast. Right. But if you look, he doesn't stab low. Okay, he can't spear fish. He doesn't stab at his ankles. So, and the arc for the spear is very, very narrow. It's like between these two rocks, not even that far. So using the spear is really good when you're like indoors. Like if you're inside the sunken crypt, the one in the swamp, it's great. You don't want to use it against skeletons, though. Pure stud weren't good against skeletons. Okay, so there's the fucking Black Forest again. My club is all wore the fuck out. Oh, look, there's a boar. Let's go kill him with the club. Hopefully I got enough skeleton parts. What's up, buddy? Alright. Alright! So that combat got a little out of hand. Yeah. But we won, yeah? We won. That's the important part. And how much room do I got? 125. Well, is there any pine trees I can snake up here? Mostly it's fir at the edge of the Black Forest, but if I can gank a pine, we'll be in business. Fir, fir, fir. That's fir. You don't normally see pine trees on the edge. Look at all these look at the pigs. Come here, buddy. Didn't want to scare that deer away, but I need the pig first. Now I need a pine tree. Is there a pine? Yeah, you think it, dude? One-on-one, you're not going to win, homie. You're just not. Okay. It's getting dark, though, and that's not a good sign. They don't usually put pine trees near the edge of the forest. They don't want to make it easy on you, yeah? Because when I start chopping down trees in the Black Forest, shit's going to come running for miles around. Okay, here's one. Okay, let's see if we can get this. Because we're going to be hacking this thing for a while. Oh, skeleton, I see you, dude. I see you. Come on. But see, look at that. Look how far away they're coming. Uh-oh, arrows? Okay, the arrow parry? How the fuck did you shoot through that tree, homie? How the hell did you do that, my friend? Up, beat, wait. Bang. Will you fucking die, dude? Jesus! See, the tree was eating up all my damage. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Come on. Come on. I liked how that skeleton shot around the tree with the wrong hand. That was pretty tits. How am I doing on buffs? 3 minutes on the strawberries, huh? Okay, if there's skeletons over here, that generally means there's a burial chamber. And it's right here. Look at that! Here it is, baby. This is where the Sirtling cores come from. So I marked these with the skeleton, just a skull. Yes, I know burial chambers. I don't need to bring a light source, dude. I can see in the dark. I'm good. Okay, let's get back to these fucking pine trees before the goddamn sun goes down. It's already down, though. We're fucked. Alright. Come on, let's go. The thing is, you can attract attention as long as you can handle what, as long as you can handle what shows up. Now, if a troll shows up, it's going to get real interesting real fast. Alright. Let's see if we can get this, yeah? We need core wood. Yeah? The problem is, my, stamina is really low and it comes back really slow here. So if I get jumped like I did before, I'm probably gonna die. Yeah, probably gonna die. Because I will not be able to fight. I literally won't have the stamina to fight. We just gotta be real careful here. Okay, last one and we can get the fuck out of here, yeah? All right. I can hear fighting over there. What's going on? It's getting louder. Is this another mound? There you are. Yeah, fuck you, dude. Alright. So it was up here. He came from this direction. Whenever skeletons, they're guarding something. It could be... Oh, he killed a deer for me. Thank you, buddy. Skeletons are normally guarding something. Whether it be a tower or a burial chamber. But this guy... was by himself. Which means I don't know where the fuck he came from. We're getting out of this Black Forest, man. You feel cold. That means it's time to go home. We should have been home a long time ago, but I needed the core wood. Alright, here we go. Now I can upgrade my club, baby. Mission fucking accomplished. I can upgrade my club. Yeah, where are you going, home? I don't think so, buddy. Did you come here? What's this? Leather scraps. Leather scraps? Okay. I'll take it. I will take it. All right. Successful journey. We've got the materials. We've got our scraps. We've got our leather hides. We've got core wood. We have some fine wood. We may be able to make this bow. Maybe. If not, that'll be some more log rolling. Remember though, sprinting makes a lot of noise. So as much as it sucks waddling along like this, it's quieter. And we are a long way from home. So normally if I was playing a normal game at this point, I would go back to that place that I marked, that house that I marked, and I would just start building it right now. It would probably attract a lot of attention, but I wouldn't have to run in the dark all the way back home like I am now to do this. Tia Tia, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. How are you doing? We're running home to the dark. Yeah, we're running home in the dark. Because we don't have easy portals yet. And our run skill sucks and our buffs are gone. And it's like, well, I got food buffs going still, so that's good. But at least we're not wet. Yeah, we're just cold and we're not rested. And look at how slow that stamina comes back, man. Hope you're staying warm there, Tia Tia. It's fucking cold. Yeah, whatever, dude. I ain't taking your shit, buddy. Nope. I need your blood to power my torches, buddy. We need your gristle for my light source. And I can't see a fucking thing. So normally there could be pigs all over the place right now, and I would never even see them. Yep. No, little mans, don't do that. Oh, I see something dripping here. Ah, pig! Yay, pig. I gotta cross this river here. Well, I'm wet anyway, so let's just go in there and get her done, yeah? Those guys have tails you can eat, but oh shit! That's not what I wanted to fucking do. Let me out of the water. Let me out of the water. Can I get out of the water, please? Most terrible fucking physics, dude. This is the worst, yeah? Well, let's just wait here for my salmon to come back. Take another shot at getting out on this 4-inch fucking... You know what? I got 66 health. Fuck this. I'll make it. But yeah, it's terrible. Yeah, it's pretty terrible. Being cold too. Well, hopefully it warms up for you, man. We're not going to get warm again until like Thursday. But yeah, this game, I don't know. I love this game, dude. It's just, it's really well designed. Doesn't have much of a story to it, but you know. It's an action-adventure survival game, pretty much. So it doesn't need one, yeah. The core gameplay loop is solid. The balance is really good. There are some jankiness to it. The jumping out of water thing and the navigating steep terrain is just it's horrifying. But that's not really exclusive to this particular title here. And little mans is looking at me like he wants something. Hang on a second. What are you doing, buddy? Come here. You want to come up? You got to come over here, buddy. Come on. Yeah, fuck it. I'll get him in a second. Okay, up we go. Then we do our, I'm not fucking with that wood down there. So first thing you do, you walk in the door, right? Fix all your weapons. Yeah, fix everything. Fix all your weapons. Right. Okay, I'm gonna sleep here really quick. You are wet. Okay, now I'm not. Now we sleep. Barely sleep because of weather effects. Nathan, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, that's, I mean, it's not so bad in the rain, but the mist, we ran into the mist earlier today. We ran into the mist before. And I was like, I'm looking for a house. I can't see a fucking thing. I'm like, this is awesome. I mean, I can't see. You know, you get people, oh, it's realistic that it's misty. I'm all, dude, this is the Norse afterlife. Have you been there recently? Can you give me the frame of reference? I heard somebody out here. I thought I heard you, little shit. Where are you? Yeah, I heard you. You're over here. Where are you? Where are you? Okay, so what we're going to do here is I got to stretch. That combat racked me up. And what we're going to do is put him here by the fire. I'm going to pause the game. I can't leave it running. We're going to put it up like this for a second. I'm going to go ahead and stretch here and tend to the little man's. 3 to 5 minutes, folks. Refill your drink, snack, smoke if you got him. Stretch like I'm going to. I'll be right back. And we are back. And thank you very much, Groucho and Glantry, for posting the links up. So what I'm going to do now... So now... Okay. So this is the early game, right? This is the early game. We're on day six. Yeah. Thank you, Noel. It's good to be back. We're on day six. We've got clear upgrade paths. Yeah. We have clear upgrade paths. We have things we absolutely need to have to do. Yeah. And, am I hearing somebody fucking my shit? Okay. Let's see if we can build a fine wood bow. Can we? Yeah, we can. Look at that. We've got what we need to build a fine wood bow. So, we're going to build a bow. Bam. And now we're going to make some wood arrows. Little man's is romping around like crazy. How much wood do I got? I got plenty of wood. Let's do this. Now, I can't upgrade the thing because I got a feeling I'm going to need, I'm going to need a hunting deer time. Yeah, he's definitely going to be hunting. Oh, the cat is playing with his toy now. And he's up on his legs. Good boy. Let's make 100 of these. Actually, 80 is enough. I don't really use that many. Let's do these. Great. Take these over here and equip them. Yeah. And we move the bow to here. Now we need to upgrade this club. Upgrade the club, baby. Hell yes. Now, you see where it says 3 and it's flashing? I need an upgrade to my workbench to upgrade the club quality. Yeah. We're not doing that right now because that's going to take me a long fucking time. At this point, okay, a skilled player, which I am not, by day 6 could be killing Ike there. They would be going to kill the boss, right? They would have all the equipment they need. They would have that, you know, they'd be able to hunt deer. They'd have the two heads they need to summon him, which is right here, right? So they could theoretically be killing Ike there. I can't do that. Let's put in the amber in this. Right, and then the food chest, we'll put those, we'll put these and this. I'm not going to cook the deer meat. Secondary crafting, we'll put the bones and the feathers. And, yeah, we'll put the pine wood in there too, and the core wood. Get that out of my inventory. And the gray dwarf eyes, put those in there. Put the deer trophies in the wealth thing here. And then this goes leather, stone and resin goes in there. Okay, cool. So this is the early game, right? This is where your upgrades come thick and fast. You're leveling, your skills go up rapidly, right? And you have all kinds of different things you need to do. Get a food supply going, you know, get your caveman meat thing going, right? And find a bee, get a beehive going, that kind of shit. But right now he's set up pretty well, right? He's doing pretty good. As you get into the later game, which I'm going to show you right now, we're going to take out Garnet here. What happens is it starts slowing down. Okay. Your upgrades are fewer and further between. Yeah. They are, they require much more resources and it takes you a lot longer to get those resources, right? It goes Stone Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age, right? Right now, she's in the Iron Age. She is at the point where she is getting ready to go kill Bone Mass. But Bone Mass, of course, is 5 fucking islands away. So I'm going to need to find a place to find him closer. I don't know if I can or not. Okay. And it's raining. Okay, so this is what a mid-game character's base looks like. This is Garnet's house. You've seen her before a long time ago. She's the one where I built that pit, you know? And I had everything down in there. And I said, fuck it. So I basically paved it over and rebuilt her house and her workshop. Yeah. So this is her camp. Her main base is this, right? With all the Ike deer heads up there, because I killed him like 8 times to get all my pickaxes, right? Because what I like to do is in every one of my little outposts, I have a basic tool set. I have a hammer, a hoe, and a flint axe, and the antler pickaxe, right? Because the antler pickaxe, I can repair at any workbench. I don't need a forge for it. Her basic house is just this. Yeah? Got all of her storage here for my overflow storage. Here's all her bronze weapons. I just upgraded her iron yesterday. Yeah? And it took me a long time to get that iron. Oh my god, it took that long. She's got her raven throne, which adds comfort. She's got her armor stand, which adds comfort. You got the table and chair. Got the rug, and on the back I got a banner. So her comfort in here is 11. Yeah. So she gets like 18 minutes. Yeah. You remember this place? Yeah, it used to be, the house used to be somewhere else. The house was like over here. If you look out here, you can see where I haven't finished. The house used to be on this platform right here. And then the portals used to be there, and the beehive used to be up over here. No, that was the beehives. The house was over here, and the portals were over there. But I basically just tucked it all back up, gave myself a bunch of workbenches around it for a safe area so they wouldn't spawn. And now her house, her main base looks like this. Right? She is what we would consider, what I guess most people would consider mid, early mid-game. That's where she's at, is early mid-game. She's in the iron, you know. I've just got all my iron weapons and my huntsman's bow made. I'm still wearing troll armor. It's rank 3 because you need obsidian to make the next upgrade to the workbench. I got my beehives, 25 beehives out of here. The basic forges and shit. And then in here is the basic workshop. With the cauldron, we got tons more storage there and a shitload more storage here. I'm not making iron chests because I don't care. And I have all my upgrades. All my upgrades. I put all my upgrades. That storm is fucking loud. I put all my upgrades. No, not that. This. I gotta get rid of that one too. Shit. I put all my upgrades up here, right? You got my tanning rack, the adds, the chopping block is back here in the corner, and then all the blacksmithing shit is over here over the forage, right? I didn't want to clutter up my ground floor, so I could build a smaller area down here. So I'm gonna put the floors back, right? So whenever I have to add a new crafting station, I just take the floor out. just do that. Yeah. Got my cooking stations here and my cauldron here. This is all my meat that I use for cooking. Meat on this side and then produce on this side. And then we got the fermenter with all the honey and shit. And then back here is the forge, yeah, with all my iron. And this holds my coal and my burnable wood for the thing here. Let's just do that. Let's add some wood while I'm here. We'll do that real quick. And then, do I have anything more to smelt? I got 10 more. We'll do those right now. One quality of life change they did that I'm very, very grateful for, I very much like, is before when you loaded these things up, you had to click the button every time to add one. Now if you hold the button, they just go in there. How many got 10, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 10 in here. But you can just hold the button down. This is so nice. Oh my god, this is such a time saver. Quality of life changes, I'm a big fan. Big fan. So now we're going to smelt some of that. So we're burning some coal. We got the forge tools here on the back. But that's it. Nice compact little settlement here with all my, you know, heads and shit up. Troll heads and whatever the fuck. And then I've got my dump spot right over there. That runestone right over there is where I dump all the shit that I want the game to recycle. Because it's just outside of my workshop area. But that's it, right? Pretty basic, pretty tribal. Has all the functions I need to do everything I need. I do not have a portal room. I simply have two portals. Because I only need two portals in my main base, right? One is general usage. The YY portal is the one I use to temporarily get around. Now, her map... Let's take off all this shit. Take off all the icons. Her exploration looks like this so far. I did find the trader. He's up here. And then I did find Hildur. She's over here. So we got that. But the problem is bone mass is way the fuck out here. And I'm like, are you serious, dude? The difficulty with him is I don't have a lot of swamp, right? There's a little nugget of swamp here. There's a tiny little strip here that's almost useless. If you go up here, it turns into the plains right there and right here and right there. It's all plains on that side of that island, so I can't do nothing with that. Lots of black forest, though. Nice, huge intro meadow, though. Huge intro meadow. This is the place where I died a couple times, and my corpse was around this little river here, so I went back and got him. But you can see that I've got bases. Well, let me turn this off. You can see that I've got outposts fairly regularly spaced around the area, right? Because I can run a really good distance now because she's higher level, higher quote-unquote level. And she can cover a lot of ground in the time she has on her rested bonus. So what I was doing is I was exploring the chambers. I found four of them down here, two of them there. That's the last one I did. And this is the one I got to work on today or whatever. There's also more swamp over here. But I know any adventurers here is going to point the bone mass who's way the fuck out here. So yeah, I just started exploring this island. I also have, which one's my farm? My farm is this one. I used the little leaf icon. I've my old base is I would put my cultivated, my farmland near in my main base. But with portals, I can put it anywhere. So I can have a dedicated base for farming, which I do have over here, where I grow my turnips and my carrots. But yeah, we've explored this entire landmass. This is a big landmass, man. You could get a lot of shit done before you had to go over the water. Because, I mean, we got a mountain here. We got a big old mountain here. We got a huge mountain range over here. Plains are here. The only thing this lacks is swamp. This thing doesn't have a lot of swamp. It's just those two. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to 07 today. Let's go to 07. Let's go ahead and explore that... Now, in for terms of food game, she runs with sausages, which give her 55 health, 18 stamina. The turnip stew, 55 stamina. Carrot soup for 45 stamina. The nice thing about these is they're buffs at the same length. They're on the same timer, right? So, what that lets me do is I'm going to put these tools up here because I'm not going to be needing them right now. I always stick them on my bed here so I remember what I was doing. So the hammer to build the portal, the workbench, and the fire inside the sunken crypt. This, of course, to mine the iron inside the crypt. And then this to get into the crypt. This thing here, people say, why don't you use an iron axe or why don't you bring more pickaxes? Because I can almost always fill my inventory before this axe breaks. Right? So I don't bother carrying more than one axe. Because every time I go back to drop the iron off, you know, I fix the axe. So that's not a big deal. Now, if I were playing with multiple players and we could haul more shit or I wanted to bother with carts, then yes, I would bring more pickaxes. So I could load the carts up and then bring them all back one at a time. But as it stands, we're doing pretty good. She got level 3 troll armor. I've got the belt. Yeah. Let's put the diverger circlet up there too. The diverger circlets are great for casting light. I use them to get to light things up. I think I did in here. Did I do it in here? Did I put one in here? No. I did on the other guy. Okay. So what we're going to do today is what I want to do is I want to check out this little nugget of swamp. I want to explore this part. See if there's anything in there I can use. See if there's a vegetable here that will point me to a bone mass that isn't 9,000 miles away. And see if I can find any sunken temples. So here's outpost number 7. So we go to 7, 7, go. Let's see what we have out here. But she is, like I said, she's an early mid game, yeah? And, okay, you hear the music, right? I built this on one of the, this camp on top of one of the Grey Dwarf fires. Because it's flat, man. Again, fairly standard. We've seen this form factor before. It's exactly the same as my other one. Got a rank 2 workbench so I can repair my armor. The portal's inside the house, yeah. So I don't have to worry about getting jumped when I go through the portal. We've got building supplies and tools in here. Nothing in here, nothing in here, nothing in here. If anything's in this chest, that tells me I need to take it home. That's the chest I dumped the stuff in. In terms of running and jumping, she is much better suited for it than the new guy. Like I said, I haven't killed Bowmass. I've killed Elder and I've killed Ike there. So now we're gonna do is we're gonna buff up. We're gonna eat our food. Put on our new gear, baby. Vantage shear and iron mace. Finally got my iron. Now I'm gonna stand here for a second because when you're resting, it triples your health regen, right? So if I stay here for a couple of seconds, wait for my rested buff, let my health get back up a little bit. We'll go for one more tick. It'll go to 97 or 98, and then we'll be out the door. At this stage of the game, she is powerful enough, and I am experienced enough with her that I just run everywhere. I don't care. If people come at me, fuck you, bro. I'll kill you. I can face tank trolls. I don't even worry. I don't even pull out a bow for them anymore. I just kill them. Tank him down with the shield and the spear. So we're going the right way. Okay. So now we go cruising, right? Making all kinds of fucking noise. I'm like, I don't care if things come out. Ooh, copper vein. I must have marked these. Too close together like this? I did not mark these. Holy shit, two copper veins? I mean, I don't really use copper very much anymore. And that's kind of a shame too. As you get up higher in the biomes, right? You'll find new plants and new metals and new materials to do things with. There isn't a lot of overlap on previous biomes materials. Blueberries, I don't pick them up, I got plenty. Like once you get into Black Forest, I mean, once you get into Swamp, you don't have a lot of use for bronze or copper or tin anymore. And it kind of sucks. I just wish there was more, or like the plants, right? Like I pick raspberries like crazy at first, raspberries and blueberries. It makes this jam, this queen's jam. Stuff's great for stamina. But once you get past the biome, you don't really use raspberries for anything except maybe putting banners up. So it's like, it's almost kind of useless. Yeah, it's sort of a shame. That's empty. All right, so here we go. Swamp. When you go from the meadows to the Black Forest, it's a pretty linear upgrade path. You don't need to do anything special necessarily. But when you go from the Black Forest to the Swamp, you do. Okay. When you pick Thistle, you get the ability to make poison resistance mead. This right here. This is a required element in the Swamp. If you do not have poison resistance on, this place will eat your fucking lunch, dude. It's not even close. It's not even funny. You will just get straight fucking murdered. So yeah, do not fuck around in here if you do not have poison. Dude, the leeches, they'll just annihilate you, dude. I mean, it's not even... Here's a Draugr. Come here, big boy. I know you hear me. Let me jump. Yeah? Nothing. Come on, big boy. Let's go. Come at me, bro. Hit him so hard. My timing on these guys is not as good as it should be. Give me your entrails. I need to make sausage. But in the water, you see the little ripples in the water. That's leeches, yeah? These guys have blood bags, and you need those for, you need blood bags for, whatever, dude. Just sit down. But see, he poisoned me, right? That shit will kill you dead, dude. Faster than you might expect or believe, because you can't do anything about it. Once you're poisoned, you're just screwed. Yeah. What do we got here? Also, I would recommend when you come here, have a jump skill of at least 40. If your jump skill is 40, it will save you a lot of grief when you're doing the mining. Because if you have a jump skill of 40, you can jump on top of the sunken crypts. And that is a lifesaver. Something. Yeah, bro. Beat the fucking shit out of you, dude. Also, it lets you get over these ancient trees once you time the jumps right. Whatever, dude. Sit down. Doesn't look like there's much in here, though. This is a pretty small segment of swamp. And I don't see a lot of anything out here. The abominations are a pain in the ass. because you really need to have fire arrows for them. But I don't know what, I don't know why you would kill them unless you wanted. Okay, there's one right there. All right, do I have fire arrows? I do. All right, let's light him up. Burn, bitch. Now, he moves pretty fast, but if you run between trees, he'll run away because he knows he can't get to you. And unlike trolls, he doesn't knock down trees, right? So I can just stay here, right? He gets bored, goes away. Sometimes he'll run a very long distance, but if you light him on fire, of course, you get lucky, he'll spawn near a Surtling Fire. You can just lure him over the Surtling Fire. And the Surtling Fire will just erase him, dude. It's hilarious. But see, look how far he goes away. He's like, he's running away, right? He's like, I can't get to you. But see, he can't fit between the trees, right? So I can just sit here and plug his ass. What's up, buddy? It's all about tactical advantages, right? Use your terrain, folks. Use your terrain. I'm gonna draw ground. Need you right now. No, sir. Don't need you right now. Kind of busy, bitches. Where'd he go? But see, now I've got a whole bunch of enemies on me. Yeah, man, you know what? Fuck you. Yeah, no, we're not doing this. Okay. We'll clean you up later. Oh, 2 1-star leeches, too. Look at that. All right. Get back to the business at hand. If I can hit him. There we go. Burn, baby, burn. Fuck off, dude. Da-na-da. Oh, he can knock shit down. Well, if he attacks me. But see, look at all this trash showing up, dude. Right, because you're fighting and it's making noise. So now I gotta deal with this bullshit, right? Switch back to my bow, and pop. Well, that could have hurt a little bit. Come on, big fella. No, we're not doing that. These take a long time to kill. I'm not quite sure what the point of them is. I mean, if you're not going for the root armor, I don't know why you would kill them. I hear more shit growling. Yeah, he takes a long fucking time to kill, man. Come on. Because you gotta wait for the burn damage to do him in, right? Because he's resistant to pierce. So regular arrows don't cut it. God damn it. And... he's almost gone. Come on, man. Hurry up and die, dude. And that'll be that. Okay, good. Let's kill these leeches. Alright. Now we're in the fucking swamp at night, and we're wet. That's not ideal, but what the hell. Pick up all this fucking wood. Because now that I've got the, are you still here? Okay. How do you get the portals? You, pick up Surtling cores. You need 20 fine wood, 10 gray dwarf eyes, and 2 Surtling cores to make a portal. Once you pick up one of those 3 items, and I think it's the Surtling cores, you learn how to make the portals. They show up in your build menu. Now it's the first one I've actually killed on her. Got some guck there? Oh, because he blew the tree down. So yeah, no, the root mass is poison resist, just his pierce resist. Ah, okay. Okay, so there's, whenever you see green lights are very rarely good. I mean, they're useful because that's where the, it's useful to know because that's where That's where the sunken crypts are. Whatever, dude. You an elite? Come on, big fella. Yeah, fuck you. Like a rented mule. I don't know what these are for. It's just this little round tower. Not quite sure what it's for, but it's cool. It'd be cooler if we could see it, but it's nighttime, so get out of the water, please. But yeah, I like, you know what? I like the stealth capabilities of the troll armor, you know. But and I don't mind making poison potions, so. But yeah, we got nothing out here, man. No tombs. No veg viseers. It's just a lump of swamp. Yeah, not much to it. Unfortunate. But I guess good for farming Draugr if I need to. Oh, here's a wraith. Come here, buddy. Come on, you want it? Come on. Yeah, I know how to block you, motherfucker. Ha ha! Give me that chain. Of course, I get chains out of the swamp now. Those guys are a pain in the ass because when they're not attacking, they flit around and up in the trees, so you don't really see them if you're not looking up. Yeah. And they only spawn at night, as far as I know. What does this say? Bone speaks to bone, remembering flesh. Okay, I hear we're near the Black Swamp here? Black Forest? Yeah. Okay. So yeah, definitely keep an eye on your poison resist. I got a minute left. I'm constantly checking it because it doesn't tell you when it expires, right? There's no message on the screen saying there's no message that tells you your buff has expired. Yeah, whatever. Yeah, I got my poison resist on, dude. You don't hurt me anyways as it is. But one shot, dude. Boom! I love my new maze. But it is a shame that troll. Okay. Wanna see some parrying action, baby? Come on, big boy. You're a one star, huh? Come on, you want it? Yeah. How about in the dick? Do you like that? Stun locked! Oh, I used to be so scared of these guys. It is so satisfying. Just face tanking his ass and going, man, fuck you, dude. You want it, bro? Come get it. And let's see. Let's get rid of what else we can get rid of. I don't need the stone. Let's grab all my coins and my troll hide. Look at that shit, baby. Hell yeah. But that's why I was mentioning before why it's a good idea to learn how to parry. That's why. Because once you got their number, and you got a weapon that they're weak to. Because what happens is, right, I get the first stun. I get the first stun, right, the first knockback. That lets me do what I think the bandage shield is 1.5 times damage. Is it 1.5? Parry bonus. So I do double damage with every hit while he's stunned. Yeah. What that allows me to do is hit him so hard and so fast that I rack up so much damage that it staggers him again. Yeah. So while he's staggered, again, I'm doing double damage. So once I get that first stagger and I got a good spear, it's game over, dude. I'll just stun lock him. He'll just be done. It is so satisfying when you get that right, man. Oh my God, it is so satisfying. I don't even need troll hides anymore. I just kill him for the fuck of it now. I kill him because I can. You got a dwarf, you got the brute, right? This guy, he swings really fast. Watch how fast he swings, right? When he winds up, it comes in quick. You have a very, very small window of opportunity to get that port. These guys killed me so many times before I realized how quick they fucking swing. Yeah? But once you get it down, see, I missed it that time. But I got it that time. I'll sit here and let him hit me, right? I'm like, whatever, dude. I need my block skill to go up, yeah? I used to run from them too, dude. I used to just engage them only with arrows and would never fucking do it. But man, I'll tell you what. Once you get their timing down, yeah? This is, be careful. I say once you get their timing down. Because until you get the timing down, you're going to die a lot. Because they will hit you so fucking hard, dude. Your kids will be born dizzy. They hit hard. For the trolls, basically, it's just before, because they have a really big windup and a really slow swing, right? In general, the time frame that you need to parry is about three quarters of the way through their swing, right? Right before they hit you is when you parry. Parry too early, you'll only block it. So when he goes up and then he brings his arms down, once his arms come down to about elbow height, that's when you nail him. But it takes practice, right? And I gotta tell you, the ones that swing the log, if you mistime the parry, yeah, it hurts, man. It hurts a lot. It hurts a lot. When you're going on Tate Trolls, make sure you got two meats and one vegetable. So you have plenty of health. That will prevent you from getting knocked back as much. Yeah, you won't get staggered. Because they can stagger you, too. And the lower your health is, the easier it is to stagger you. So you definitely want to... You definitely want to have... good meat going. Yeah. But see, not bad. And I just... go ahead and fix my armor real quick. I can't fix my weapons because I got to go to the forge to fix the weapons. Okay, so we're going to go back. We're going to go back. Go back to our house here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to get our stuff out. We're going to put this stuff away. Now we do maintenance, right? Come back, fix our weapons, fix our armor. Put you away there. Let me go ahead and put my money away. I always forget to do this. My money chest is here. I put my valuables in there until it's full, and then I take them to the vendor. What do I got in here? Chains, guck. Right. Okay. I didn't pick up any plants. The carrots. I put the seeds in here for now. I'll take those back to my base later. 30, 50, 250. Blood bags go here? No. Here. No, they go here. Yeah, I moved them the other day and I forgot where I put them. Smells like fermented fish. My first guck, I haven't gotten a guck yet. Alright. And then my things go here. And the troll hides go here. No. Here? Come on, where the fuck did I put the troll hides? There they go. And then the chain goes over here with the processed metal products. But yeah, you just open the chest up, click the right stick, and it just puts it away. Such a handy, time-saving thing. It's just, oh my god. Alright, now we're gonna get some more iron, right? Let's go get some more iron. I need to bring some wood with me, because I don't think I've been inside that last one. Let's bring 5 wood. And I'll show you what a sunken crypt looks like. I got plenty of food, I got 7 minutes left on my buffs, right? Got plenty of time for everything. I don't know if I've already opened it, so we're going to bring that, and we're going to bring this, and we're going to bring the hammer. Because of course there's a... oh, green banner, okay. So now we go back to the other swamp, right? Where my temporary portal is. Okay, I heard the door open, so I don't need the swamp key. So what you do, right, is you jump up on top of these little crypts. You'll see them with the little green lights out in front, right? You jump up on top of here, you build a workbench, you build a portal right on top, right? Nothing can get up here. The abominations can hit you if you get up here, but for the most part, you're fine. Now, I don't know if I've actually cleared this one or not, so we're going to go look inside. Is there a fire burning? There is no fire burning. That means I've either not cleared this thing or I've cleared it and I'm getting ready to go. It looks like I've cleared it. Going to the left, is this chest have anything in it? No. Okay, this place is empty. I don't even want to think about what this place smells like, man. The smell in this place would be fucking awful. So what I do is I run around in the swamp first, right? Poison on, killing shit, whatever the fuck. And I'm looking for these tombs and I mark them with a little skull. When I've cleared them out, I X them out. Yeah, so I've cleared all 4 of those and that 5th one there. Once I'm done, I bust out the hammer. Let's move the hammer here. Let's move my tools around so I know what I'm doing here. You bust out the hammer. Yeah. Take down the portal. Get all your stuff back. Take down the workbench. Get all your wood back. Now we go over to the next one. Uh-oh. Don't forget to put on the poison. Oh, shit. I forgot to bring rocks. Fuck me. That's okay. Maybe there'll be some in this thing here. What's in here? Empty. Okay. So I need some rocks. So what you want to do, right, is you build a campfire inside here. Yeah. But I need rocks. Are there any rocks by the shore here? Anything I can gank here? Just need a rock that I can chip away at with that pickaxe. Here's a rock here. A stone? One, two, three. Is that one over there? Come on, man. I need a little stone here. Yeah, this'll work. This will be fine. Let's break this stone down. Just need some stone. There we go. Added stone 6. Perfect. Alright. So, we prep. Yeah. Here's our new place. We've never been in here before. Jump up on the top. Whee! Jump on the top. Build yourself a workbench. The workbench has two functions. One, it allows you to build a portal. And two, it keeps things from spawning too close to you. Yeah? So now we build our portal. Yeah? I name my temporary portals YY for a very efficient reason on Xbox. That reason is when I go to name it, it starts on the letter Y. So I just tap A twice, start, done. And it'll go boosh. Alright. So now I can get home. Yeah. And since I've got portal restrictions turned off. Fuck, I forgot the diverger circlet. Okay. We need to go back home real quick. Also, being nice, being connected to your house, very handy for this particular function. Because you can get your rested bonus back up, yeah? Alright, let's see what we got here. Let's put the swamp key up and grab the diverger circlet. It's right there. Normally, I don't use these things, but I do in the crypts, because you can't be stealthy in a crypt. You're basically smashing the place down. So it's like, they know you're there, man. There's no sneaking, yeah? And let's top everything up before we go back out. Okay, in we go. And back out. So when it comes to the slowness of the progression, right? At first, to upgrade your weapons and armor, you just need to pick up rocks and cut down trees. That's it, right? Pick up rocks, cut down trees, kill pigs, kill deer. That's how you upgrade your gear, right? After you kill Ike Deer, you get something called hardened antlers. And this allows you to make a pickaxe, right? This is where the game slows down, okay? Because you need to mine copper and tin, smelt them into bars, and make bronze. You need a lot of bronze to make weapons and armor. Okay. Then on top of that, once you get them upgraded, you go for iron, which is where I am now. I'm getting iron. Iron takes even more. It is frankly shocking how much iron it takes to make stuff. Yeah. So you're going to be doing this shit all the time. You get iron from these scrap piles, and you can get it from, sometimes the chests will have iron in them. Iron weighs 10 pounds per ore, and it weighs 10 pounds per ore, so you can't carry much. 30 a trip. There's a jogger standing right there. Look at it. Whatever, dude. Fuck you. Now, in here, it's almost better to use a spear. Because the spear, right, The spear shoots straight ahead of you. Yeah. Which means you're not, you don't lose damage by hitting the sides of the walls. Yeah. It's about one of its, it's one of its few good functions. Okay. We got that. Now I can hear in here. See, hold on a second. In here, you can hear that buzzing. That's one of the the gut files, right? That's a draugr spawner. So, you can go one of two ways with those. You can smash as fast as possible, or you can sit there and farm it to skill up. Because it will keep spawning draugr until you smash it. See, we got some poison arrows. And that. Okay. Like this, like on all the things, I my method is I hug the right-hand wall. And that way, I'll see everything. I heard you, homie. Come on, man. You want some, bro? Yeah, whatever. Yeah, sit down. Okay, what's in the chest? Anything in the chest? No, rubies. Money, 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 money. These places are pretty good for money. This is why it's good to have the Diverger circle on, so you can see in the corners and see where the loot is on these side panels. But this is, these things here, this hacking these muddy scrap piles, going back to your base with iron, smelting it down and then making stuff. It will take you, even with the portals turned off, right? Even with the portal restrictions turned off, it will take you 8 to 12 hours to upgrade your character just doing this. You'll be doing this over and over and over. Smashing muddy scrap piles, getting scrap iron, getting over encumbered, jumping to the portal, going back to base. Now, before you could turn off the portal restrictions, you had to, come on, I know it's there, dude. Come on. Give it to me. There it is. You had to actually run back to your base, and I'm like, no, I'm not doing that. That's just not fun, dude. So, I turn off raids, I turn off portal restrictions, and I'm on very easy. And that's pretty much it. I don't do the, you know, unlimited resources. I don't do, you know, the resources are standard. Everything's standard. I just suck at combat, so I've got to, there's a blob. How's my acid protection? Okay, acid's good. Oh, I don't like these rooms. Too many obstacles. Okay. All right. Put on the mace because he's weak to he's weak to Oh, you're stuck. You can't get to me. Well, if you can't get to me, why'd you shoot you in the face? You can do that. Yeah, you hate that, don't you? Still can't get to me, homie. La-dee-dee. All right, let's get this blob here. Hope it didn't put the light out. All right, blob's done. This room's a fucking mess, man. Get the amber. What's in the chest? There's some iron. 13 iron right there. And I'm up to 379 pounds already, yeah? I got 28 on me. Alright. I can usually get about 30, 34 with all the other shit that I carry. You know, the coins and the brains and the stones and all the other shit that I gotta deal with. But this is where a lot of people, the swamp, if you're not prepared for it, right? The swamp, I would imagine, is where a lot of people stop playing. Because this biome is where the difficulty really gets going. Yeah. Both in terms of, protections needed, and, yeah, I can't get that one. And just in terms of how long it takes to progress. I mean, you will spend 20, 30, 40 hours in the swamp doing nothing but what I'm doing right fucking now. Just to upgrade your shit, yeah? And I'm not even doing armor, I just did weapons, yeah? I didn't even do rank 4, I only did rank 3. Because I'm like, by doing the mace. The mace, upgrading a mace to level 3 takes about 60 iron, okay? Which is literally, for me, two full trips of doing nothing but this, scavenging this thing. It's obnoxious, dude. Can you make stone buildings? Yes, you can make stone buildings. Once you unlock iron, you get the ability to build a stone cutter. And this allows you to make, let me see what I can drop off here. I don't need a draugr head. I do want the chains. 448, okay? So you've been in here for what? 10 minutes? We're done, we're leaving. We gotta go, right? I'm full, I can't carry anything more. So now I just go back out the way I came in, little man's. I see you down there, buddy, you're gonna come up. I don't have poison protection on anymore, which is a little problematic. Okay, so there we go, right? There's our foray. Now we go back home. I see a little man. I see we're getting close to time here. So what I'm going to do then... Yeah, let's do this. Let's go back to base. We do our normal survival mode shit, right? We redo our... We fix all our shit. We unload. We dump. We put stuff away. We fix all our crap. Then we go back out. Yeah, let me make the stone cutter. I generally don't make the stone cutter because I don't really care about the about that kind of stuff. Put that and that and that. Anything else do I have in here? No. Okay. So we go out here, we fix our armor and our hammer. And then we go over here and we fix our weapon armor. We put all this shit away. Leather. Goes down, the bone goes in here, leather goes down here, yeah. And the stone, I don't need that much stone, so we'll put that in there. Then we go out here, is it ready to tap? It's ready to tap. All right, I'll do that in a second. Grab our charcoal, put it away. And then, put the chains away, put the iron away. I'm not gonna smelt it right now, I'm not gonna deal with it. And then we put the arrows away. I keep the arrows for some reason. I don't know why I keep them. I've got the storage, so I figure why not put them in there. Okay, so, stone cutter. The stone cutter requires 10 wood, 2 iron, 4 stone. 10 wood, 2 iron, 4 stone. 10 wood. 10 wood, 2 iron, and 4 stone. So I'll show you what you get to do with that. The thing about the stone cutter that I don't like is that it has to be near a forge, and you can only build stone near where it's at. Yeah. So it has limited functionality because I don't want workbenches scattered all over my goddamn place. I like, you know, narrow stuff. But let's do this. So we're gonna build the stone cutter. Right. But see, it has to be near a workbench. I'm sorry, it has to be near a workbench. So we're just going to drop it out here in the middle of things. I got two workbenches around here. Let's just do that. We'll put it right here in the thing. Yeah? I'm going to stick it right there. And now I can build sharpening stone, hearth, stone wall, stone pillar, stone arch. Crap, it's easy to move. I don't care. So now if I go into build mode, in building, I can build that stone block, this stone wall, a 4x2 stone wall, stone pillars, stone archways, stone floor, 2x2, stone stairways, and then the cage floors, all this shit came with the iron. And a wood shutter, apparently. What's this? Oh, look at that! I can put the little... Oh, isn't this cute? I can put shutters over my... I mean, I wouldn't, because it's the fireplace. But yeah, you can make stone buildings, and a lot of people do. Make stone towers and shit. It just takes an ass load of stone. And, so stone cutter, and that's... We don't have anything new in here, right? I got no new upgrades. And then in furniture, I don't think there's anything new in furniture. Personal chest, but that's just iron and flint and wood. Oh, a stone throne! You can make a stone throne. Look at that. What else we got in here? Banners, yeah. Wolf rug. Need to make one of those. Need to go hunt some wolves. I actually killed two by mistake one time. And that's it. And then the dragon bed, which needs wolf pelts. I can't get those yet. But yeah, so you can build a stone. That's all you need to do is build that particular crafting station to do it. Yeah, not too bad. I might fart around with stone building someday, you know. It's just I like the hominess of wood, yeah. And I don't get raided. If I had raids on, I would definitely be building in stone. Okay, no doubt about it. I'd be building in stone. If I had raids, because it's a lot more durable than wood. Yeah, which seems obvious. But there it is. All right, let's go put her stuff away here. And it's in here. Yeah, 10 of those. All right, let's go put the stone and shit away. Put all our stuff away, right? Put all our stuff away. You can make signs to label things as well. Yeah, he needs a little bit of wood and a little bit of charcoal. But I don't, because I don't really need to. I know where all my stuff is. Generally, I sometimes have to search a little bit to find them. But since I play by myself and nobody else has to know where my stuff is, I don't need to label it. And I've got this is a pretty mild storage unit, yeah? I've seen some people's builds where they've got like hundreds of iron chests, dude. I'm like, damn, son. But this is homey. This is cozy. I like this. It's kind of barbaric with all the Ike Deer heads above me. This is my personal storage. Most of these are empty. I haven't really used these for anything. This is my overflow storage. Yeah. These are my trophies from the Black Forest. My trophies from Meadows, Black Forest, Swamp. All my trophies here. I've only gotten one Elite Draugr head so far, though. I know you need those for crafting some shit later. I'm not quite sure what, but something. Yeah. Okay. So there we are. There's our thing. Let's go ahead and sit in our throne. Heavy is the head, yeah? Heavy is the head. So with that, yeah, I guess we're closing up the time. I want to thank y'all for stopping by, sharing your Sunday with me for the up to 3 hours and change that you did, if you did. If you had a good time today, appreciate you clicking that like button. Feed that YouTube algorithm and services for more people to see, and maybe they'll like it and stop by and hang out and chat and shoot the breeze with us and y'all and watch the whatever crazy shit's going on the screen at any given time. If you're new to the channel, this is the first thing you're seeing and you like this kind of thing, click subscribe. There will be more of this kind of thing. I stream something on Sunday starting at noon central. Today it was Valheim, before it's been 76. If No Man's Sky ever updates again, I'll probably stream that maybe, see how that goes. For next week, maybe Valheim again, maybe we'll take our little, maybe I'll just leave our little scrub out there, and we'll go around hunting with him next week, leave him where he's at, and see if we can make him grow up a little bit. As always and as ever, I want to thank y'all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care, y'all.